She can sit where she likes. Goat thinks the sub. Hi, Limmy, please, can I have a Dragon Ball Z? Came, Haim, Ha, Fireball, Blam, please. Came, or Kami, or Hami, or Haim, Ha. Nust, Axe, Jammy, and Mikey thinks the subs. The Blam's been taken. I don't know what that is. I might have seen that game once. I don't know. Is it a fighting game? You give me an obscure reference. It's fucked. Forget it. Dragon Ball Z, see? It's got the letter Z there. And people are saying, haha, it's no Z. It's Z. I'm interested in your stupid wee lives. What is it, isn't it? Will there be only 7 subs in the top 10? Let's put that down to 4. Will there be only... I'm going to guess 4.
Does that mean I have to have my legs in the air?
That's too loud. That's too loud.
Well, I don't have a vase, do I?
That's too loud. Geith Bravey, Loxley, Fulton. Thanks for the subs. Thank you very much. Jammy, the thanks to the bits, the Blam's been taken. This is the story of my life. Red Sauce. Geith, thanks to subs. Ark Survival Evolved. I looked it up. Some people said, no, here's why you don't want to play it. I can't remember the reason. Ferguson Zorab. Thanks to subs. I can't remember. There was a reason it goes on for like 100 hours or it's dead complicated or the numbers or some shit. I can't quite remember. What happened to your letterbox? I did one thing. I can't be asked doing another. Alright, let's go. I've installed Red Dead Redemption 2 and I had a wee shot at it last night for about 2 minutes. Completely forgot the fucking controls. But I'm gonna get Dave the Diver, Sam. I'm definitely gonna get it, but not today. Just feel like shooting some. I feel like being cruel. Awkward and SG, Gizmo, Veritas, thanks to subs. Why are you not on Twitter anymore? It's on my pinned post. Why don't you read my Twitter? Joe Bananas and Awkward, thanks to subs. Sophie, thanks to sub. I will tell Bobby that. It's there. My latest tweet and the pinned tweet explains. Dr. Awkward thinks a sub. Scott Replay and Paul, thank you very much. Mank Snake thinks a sub. Have you heard the Pet Shop Boys remix of Noel Gallagher's song Think of a Number? I haven't. If you have, what do you think it? Non-applicable, any. Cammy thinks a sub. Thank you very much. The bet's done, yep. Too late. Lots to get on by. Let's not fuck about.
Sorry, Neville. No more. No more. Fan mail. Fan mail. Sorry, Neville.
So Kate Bush. No more. No more. Really boosted the 5K. You know, you get that right high end with Kate Bush, because no really, really boosts the 5K. No 5K for us, waiting for somebody to say it. Now, what do I mean by that? Do you remember yesterday I was talking about the Ballad of Dorothy Parker by Prince? And the sound engineer Susan Rogers talking about how because it was a new console and there was a problem with the voltage or something that she didn't know until after. It's got a kind of low pass sort of muffled sound to it. She said in this interview that I read, she said, it's basically, it sounded almost like the opposite of sort of like Kate Bush, where it's like a lot of high end. Because Kate would really boost, like run about the 5K mark, 5,000 kilohertz. Or is it 5 kilohertz? Or 5,000 kilohertz? 5 kilohertz? Aye. So it's like, all right, we'll start then. Where would that be? So I thought, see if I did any wee vocal things, I'm going to boost the 5K to see if I can make myself sound like Kate Bush. We're fucking back.
Like Turkish delight.
We're back.
I do. A lot of people don't like Turkish delight. I mean, fries Turkish delight.
Thank you very much, everybody.
Purple rapper.
I thought it was funny.
I like it. A lot of people say, oh,
are you doing drugs since
Turkish
the sub?
Turkish delight, that's disgusting. How can you... How
what's the most physically painful thing you've ever done?
Perfume. It's like eating old woman's perfume. Like lavender water. Or rose water. Or whatever it is. How can you like that? I like it. I like Turkish delight. I don't like it enough to get it every day. Or every week. In fact, I can't remember the last time I got a Turkish delight. But every now and then...
I think I might have...
I'll be in a
It wasn't a huge shite.
And I walk past the shelves or the chocolate. And I'll see a Turkish delight and...
Janvik,
I'll get it.
Kiki thinks of subs and bits.
It's nice.
Would you recommend going for a holiday this year? I hear oranges
are
delicious.
Turkish delight.
So, Bill, this time of year, you've just activated the cell. Barnes, the Trop, Snared, Cammy, Scott Replay, Barnes. Do you like being ours sitting down or stone up? 50-50. I've not got any set way of doing it. Chancel, thanks to subs and bits. When's the last time you embarrassed, humiliated yourself? Embarrassed. I really don't know. 24 Ducks, thanks to sub. What's your death row final meal? Big Mac meal. Strawberry milkshake. August Latrine, Bane in the Neck, Drip, Cam, Mackay, and Schlug, thanks to subs. Can you pretend to treat me like that? I'm not close pairs of friends. Jealousy of the. All right. And keep a distance. Painful thing. I remember I had a wank. Like in a hand cream sort of thing once, and I think after it, when I did a pish later, it stung like basically holding a fucking match to the end of my cock. So it's as if maybe something got up me and made it sensitive. Cartoons, thanks to the sub. Barnes, Matty and Michelangelo, Massingbird, thanks to the subs, thank you very much. Remember, this is educational. Man's lunch goes missing. I'm in a meeting. Right. Congrats. Lots to get through. Man's lunch goes missing.
Does that mean I have to have my legs in the air all night? Well, I don't have a vase, do I?
Medi and Copex, thanks to the subs. That's an old video, that. Any life advice? Moved into his first home. Enjoy yourself. Enjoy your time. Young time. Bobby Swinger. Lap. Thanks to subs. John Boy, thanks to sub. Did you see the new Texas Chainsaw Massacre game coming out on a Game Pass? Sort of Dead by Daylight, Friday 13th. It sounds interesting. I'll look into it. I've never heard of that. going to be a hard one today, man. Not bitter at all, says Iceline. How is that bitter? I fucking watched the trailer and gameplay stuff on the stream for that Texas Chainsaw Massacre game. I've spoken about it various times. That's why I'm like that. That's not called being bitter. Just ban chat. I fucking should. Everybody should be banned and then you make your way back for that. Prove your worth. Jamie J, thanks for the sub. 4 whole years. Thank you very much. Where's my fucking question? This not get. Thanks for the sub. Thank you very much. Dion, thanks for the sub. Thank you very much. Man's lunch goes missing. Let the story commence. Craig was sitting on a park bench with his lunch. It was a sandwich just like that there. And he put it down on the bench. Run out, right. And looked that way, looked back to pick it up. And actually, you know, this happened so quickly that he went like that, look. He went to pick it up, right? And he's like holding it like that. There's nothing there. He didn't clock. There's nothing there. He went like that. Nearly bit his fingers. Picked up, thought he was picking up the sandwich because it was right there. He, you know, he put his sandwich there, right? He went like that. Park bench. Nearly bit his fucking fingers right off because it happened that quickly. Somebody, his lunch has gone missing or went missing, gone missing. Just completely vanished. And there was somebody on the bench next to him and he knew that they couldn't have taken it. But there was nobody else around and it wasn't there and it wasn't under the bench. And he said, and it was an old guy, just an old guy minding his own business. He was about 80, brittle bones and things like that. And he just ran up. He ran up to him to kick his head right off his fucking neck. And then thought, wait a minute, I need to do my due diligence here. And said, hi sir, just investigating here. My sandwich there is gone. An old guy went like that. What's that? You know, I don't fucking make out that you're all old and, oh, what's going on? I'm not fucking daft. And he went like that. Look at this. Look at this one. Know that one. Look at this one. Punched his fucking head right up into there. About the height of a basketball hoop. That high. Head's right off his fucking neck. And then some wee guys walked by. No, three wee guys, just wee guys. And as the heat was coming down, Craig went like, yeah, boys, look at this. And he went like, and it just turned to dust because he fucking hit it that hard that it shattered the, because of the brittle bones. But he hadn't, when he punched the heat up, he'd fucked the integrity of the bone, so wasn't he broken apart? Wasn't the face was all broken apart into pieces? It shattered the integrity. Yeah. So all it took after that was this, and it just turned to fucking dust like this. I'll show you. It's the difference between putting a brick through a window and shattering glass hammer. That's the one. Like that. Look at that. Sort of tiny wee pieces. Oof. She must do this all the fucking time. Look, she must do this all the time. I don't think I would ever get tired of that.
But it should have a big sheet of fold that you could just fold right out.
What if your car has wind right up here in the corner?
Michael. See that? That there.
I'm going to try up here in the corner.
That's just that's the kind of hammer version. So that's no, like, oh, it puts a hole. The whole thing's fucked. Look at that, man. And you can just do this, look. There you go. Look at that, look at it works. And then?
Side, with that smashed, I'm going to have to push on the window.
Look at that. Look at that. That's a special sort of glass.
It just came out that easy.
Thanks for watching.
He's happy. He likes it. And there it is. And that's what he, well, shattered into a million pieces. And the wee guys went like, wow. And then, you know how you got fireworks? And some people are like, let's get rid of fireworks and let's have drones. Some of these fucking things with drones, just nice big 3D fucking things in the move. Let's do that so that we're not scaring dogs and cats and, you know, people are getting burnt and things like that. No. A guy walked by, a kind of rich, a billionaire Texan, a big 12-gallon hat, whatever the fuck it is. We went like that. You know, I'm going to make this in a big idea. And that became the new fireworks. Punching an old guy's head right into the fucking sky. Only, obviously, you've got to date with lots of old guys. Then you've got to date with industrial strength fucking fist, mechanical fist. Knocking them up. And then you just blow a wind. And it goes like that. But these are all guys who want to give their life. It takes a wee bit of persuasion, but everything takes a bit of persuasion. The end. Super Funko, that's a true story, by the way. How do I know? I was pickpocketing the billionaire at the time. I didn't mention that I was there because I don't want to fucking incriminate myself, but I was pickpocketing the billionaire, so I had heard the whole thing. Copez, Super Funky One, Cara, Jody thinks the subs. Ali Crooks and 19 thinks the subs. Oh, finger up your ass. Good, good, good. Doctors. Zinkit and Kiri, sick boy, very terrible man. This not get. Thanks to the subs, thank you very much. Where did the sandwich go? Don't know. I do not know, to be honest with you. Fuck this, get Cheddars on, says Acorn Electron. Give us a second. Cheddars. Google Map, USA. Cheddars. Okay. Right. 4.4 out of 5. Just wow. 5 out of 5. Newest. Yep, absolutely love the food and the portions they have to offer here. Love the Monte Crisco. However, a recent visit led to his lack of communication skills and smiling. Still 5 out of 5, though. Any pictures? Excuse me a second. If I click on... I close that. Can I click on that? Right. Newest. 3 out of 5. Food was okay, nothing special. Salad was fresh, drink was good, but for a Long Island iced tea was on the weak side. Oh, likes a drink. Don Fernandez likes a Long Island iced tea. A wee bit merry a kick. Bring your own wee fucking hip flask in. Now, it goes for 5 out of 5 to 5 out of 5. Not quite happy with the waitress, but still 5 to 3. To a day ago, Willie Lozano. Worked there for a minute. Dirtiest kitchen I ever worked. They buy the lowest grade food. That's why it's so cheap prices. Microwave is used for most dishes except burgers, fish and rib and steak. What a fucking grass. Let my family and friends to never eat there if they care about their health. That's fucking libel, that. That's libel. Now, Willie, you've done 2 reviews. What if I click on this and there's another review of you saying, oh, I worked in this McDonald's for a minute. Let's see. Yep. 5 days ago. Terrible service. 1 star out of 5. Squared up pizza. Just around the corner. Look, just along the road. Terrible service. Employees look upset, unhappy to work there. Pizza is overrated and overpriced and ordered a whole pie. It's funny how they call it a pie earlier, a pizza pie, instead of just a whole pizza. Ordered a whole pie and it was overcooked. So disappointed after hearing great things. Stick to Pizza Hut or Domino's. Lol. Well, they've got a laugh at it. They've got a wee laugh at it. They laughed out loud as they were typing their review. There you are. That's something. You should get a fucking star. You should, if you're going to get 1 out of 5, the second you did the LOL, bump it up to 2 out of 5, because at least you got a laugh at it. Bud Dusky, and I know why. D-Wheel for GMAC. Thanks for subs. I've watched all but one of the new Black Mirror ones. What's your favourite John Carpenter film? Did he direct maybe the thing? Did he direct Halloween 3? Now Mariachi, thanks for sub. World famous clown motel, can you believe we found that? He didn't? No, he didn't, right. Hey hey funnies. Paul Scott, thanks for subs. Got to Turkey today, any words of wisdom? See, when you're there, get a wee transplant for me. Get yourself one and get one for me as well. Bane in the neck, thanks for the bits. Did you like the scene in Jojo Rabbit when they say that saying over and over again? I don't know what you're talking about. I know the film, I watched a bit of it and then just switched it off. But I can picture it. I can picture it in my head. And I'll just say that I didn't like it. G-Hus, thanks to sub. Yo, bro, I can't access episodes of the Lammy's House show here in the States. Is it not available here? I don't think so. I'll be putting it on... I've put a lot of it. I've uploaded a lot of individual sketches to my YouTube. 5 out of 5, 4 out of 5. Now we're talking. Came in on a Friday around 4:15 and the hostesses took our names, so we thought. People who came in after us all got seated, the worst. People who came in after us, something, something, something. That's the worst. After being seated, we were told no server was assigned to our area. Lol. There you go, another wee laugh. So maybe that was going to be a 1 out of 5. and this went up to 2 out of 5 after the type lol. Then a cheesecake was delivered right before we even ordered. Maybe this was an off night, but just felt unorganised chaos. Bus boys walking around with earbuds and texting as they walk around with their tub. Floors were so dirty, covered with debris, and they still sat people at a table that was destroyed with food all over the floor. Servers standing around laughing out loud. Oh, we hate that. Not doing a thing. You don't need to type laughing out loud, by the way. If you see up there, see that LOL? That's what that stands for. Manager needs to go to restaurant school. Wasn't like this a year ago. Oh dear. Let's see. Sorry, what am I meant to be looking at here? That there? I mean, surely you don't mean this here, because as you can see, that's out of focus. All I can see here is that table, which looks perfectly clean. And what's that? An urn? Is that grey hair? Late 40s like me, 50s, grumpy. Grumpy old guy like myself, never happy. Never happy. Never thought of 1 out of 5. Never thought that I would say this, but Cheddar's is going downhill. Their food is starting to taste bad, and their fountain drinks taste like they're off. By the time the food got to the table, it was cold. I don't think I'll be coming back for a while. 2 reviews. Oh, no, 28 reviews. That was almost 2 weeks ago. Let's see. Anelica Alvarez. Let's see what other ones. Ah, oh, fuck. Oh, Jesus. Oh, it's bad, bad, bad. A few good ones. Fuck me, man. They hate this. They hate this place. Chick-fil-A. I used to go here all the time. I was so excited to eat here today, but the food was not fresh as it always is. What a waste of money. I won't be coming back to this location. There's that double M again, we're coming. What is it? How'd you say it? Philly? Chick Philly? Or what, they say it like that? I don't know, we don't have it here. Chick-fil-A. Fucking fillet. We don't say filet. How do they say it there? Do they say, is it Chick-fil-A or Chick-fil-A? How did they say it in this, the name of this company? Chick-fil-A. Get the fuck, man. Forcing me to pronounce it that way by putting it in the name of the actual. Bastards. Right, so I'm seeing what might be a pattern emerging. Everything used to be better in the old days. I'm sure it was better. Went to Millport, wasn't as good as what I remembered it. 1 out of 5. Went back to that old pub that I used to go to when I was 20. Different people there, and pub's got a different name. 1 out of 5. I see. Defy Tucson. It is overpriced. CSL Plasma. Valentina is the worst. 1 out of 5. What the fuck is Valentina? Tucson. Is that how you say it? Tucson. Tucson. Oh, I'm so sorry. So did I say Tucson wrong? It's Tucson. How many people from fucking Tucson or Tucson know how to say Ochtamachty? Carol's Jr. This place needs a health inspection. Spent $50 there and got party soda. Have I said that right, everybody? Party soda, P-A-R-T-I. Or is it party? Parti Sudan, and found a hair on my chicken sandwich. Could have been yours. Could have been yours. 3 out of 5 for a fucking Walmart. Angry Crab Shack. Honest review, 1 out of 5, by the way. Honest review, today was the first time I ate here, and it will be the last time. So this isn't like, it used to be good here, now it isn't anymore. Today was the first time I ate here, and it will be the last time. The quality of the food is not good. After I ate it, my body did not take it well. I had a huge stomach ache, which has never occurred before from eating seafood. I ate this for lunch, and I did not eat breakfast, so I know it was the food. I spent $90 just for myself. It is way overpriced and overhyped. Lakewood Church? 1 out of 5 for a fucking church? I need to see this. For a church? No. Maybe it's got a bookshop in it. Let me go here. It's a car park. Get me out of here. Where's the front there? The church is there, look. Look at this. Right, 1 out of 5? Let's see what other ratings this church's getting. 4 out of 6. How do you rate a fucking church? Oh my god. Blessed, forgiven, victorious, anointed, free, amazing. Look at this, eh? I mean, I've seen things like this. Jesus. Ha! Jesus! I said Jesus. Maguire and Fox Mulder, thanks to subs. No, pause. No, there's your applause. SBS, sweet cup of tea, Sean, L, sweet dude, Eddie, Huss, thanks to subs. Which Next Generation crew member would you fight to the death on the holodeck? Tops off, Spike Macy's. Him who... Mad Murdoch. Have I caught up? Captain Cocked. Thanks for the sub. Mad Murdoch. Barclay, aye. Look at this. Look at this, eh? Legacy, I hope. Wait a minute. It's him. What's his name? Oh, you kind of see. Can you? What's his name again? I've watched him before. Him when he let people into his church during that hurricane, whatever the fuck it was. What's his name? Joel Austin. Aye. Is that where he is? Is this his church? Have I just stumbled upon his church? Probably a franchise. Aye, that makes sense. Because it's got this two here, then them. Hold on. Joel Austin. Where's your church? Have you got a church? Have you got, like... What's that? I just saw it. I saw it pop up. In 2000, Lakewood Church's weekly service. Right, Lakewood. Lakewood Church. So is this the one where he started? Under his 40? Right, I'll look again. Hold on. Joel Austin. Preaching in 2016. It's that I've just stumbled upon it because I've watched him before. I've watched his stuff before. A non-denominational evangelical Christian mega church located in Houston. Have I just stumbled upon? Have I stumbled upon that? This is a sign. Wait a minute. That's not the same place. That's not the same place. Is it? No. So there's, but there's multiple. There's multiple. No. No, this isn't the same place. This is a review. By, what do you call it? I'm getting mixed up. Right, who was the person? Who was it again? Was it them? Where am I on the map? Is it there? Ah, it's here. Go back. I see. Texas? Aye. It's the, yes. That was the one that just got 1 out of 5. Right, give me the fucking lowest rating. This is a good church for those who are starting out as a baby Christian, says Robert Segovia. Great uplifting message, just in case you're like, what are you on about? Who's this Joel?
Looking everywhere.
We'll leave it there, Joel. Right, so let's see the reviews of Lakewood Church, which is his church. This is a good church for those who are starting out as a baby Christian. Great uplifting message, but it'll get stagnant after a while. But when you're ready to go to the next level, because us Christians need more, an Acts way of living, and the Holy Spirit will let you know. I was at Lakewood for 14 years, and although I have some great experiences and memories there, but I needed more of God. To God be the glory. 1 out of 5! You were there for 14 fucking years. You'll get 2? 2 out of 5? Some fucking Christian you are. This is Old Testament. This is Old Testament thinking. This is vengeful. 0 stars. Well, it's no, it's 1. You're a liar. And you're lying in the name of fucking God, by the way. You're going to hell. 0 stars. The absolute epitome of a wolf in sheep's clothing. Many people don't have the critical thinking skills and or intelligence to discern. Christianity is the most confusing endeavour that one... This is a church! This is a fucking church. There are millions of interpretations of the Holy Bible, and I already know that some will proclaim that it's simply a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. Well, for the unbelievers, I can't help but agree with them on hundreds of questions, reason, comments, with logic always triumphs. Who am I to deny that God made my brain, heart, and every fibre and being designed? I absolutely can't believe. That's a review of Christianity and religion in general. We're talking about the church. This isn't the fucking place for that. That's like me getting a particular branch of McDonald's 1 out of 5 because I'm a fucking vegan. Or like a seafood restaurant, getting it 1 out of 5 and going, I don't like seafood. Very disappointed. 1 out of 5. These are ordered by Lois, by the way. Very disappointed. I wanted to believe and be involved. At the end of one of his sermons, I decided to make a donation and ordered a book. It's been a month and I never received a book, but they cashed my check. Ara yara. I called Sunday morning and they told me that they have no history of my order. Really? You cashed my check. I also have noticed Joel talks about the same thing over and over again about abundance and what people can get. That's not what life is about. There are more serious problems in this world and people have other issues to worry about and deal with. He sounds like a broken record and talks about the same thing over and over again. Update. I did finally receive the little pamphlet a month later. My opinion on Jeff's sermons has not changed. 1 out of 5. It's not looking good here. She sounds like a broken record, says Thomas Griggs. Nice, Thomas is like, she sounds like a broken record. Nice one. Thomas is in for Joel Osteen Ministries. Elizabeth, employees of this church use their church email to harass people. Whether or not this is sanctioned by the church, it is happening, and they should do better to be more Christ-like. Jesus didn't use email. Jesus taught love and acceptance, not vitriol and bullying. Oh, right, I thought you were talking about the technology. Because I was thinking, I don't think they had it back then. Thanks, everybody. Cheers. Thank you. You would have been lucky to get a fucking a letter through the post, through the Royal Mail with Jesus back then, never mind an email. Kilferius and Thrill Hughes, thanks to subs. Thank you, a resub rebate. No, the holidays included. Is there a problem here, thanks to the sub? Me going on holiday isn't me neglecting my streaming duties. I went to Lakewood every week and was wondering if I could talk to Pastor Joel Osteen in person. Of course no! What? And they come up with the reason. I make a phone call to make a prayer request and I was explaining and the lady put me off saying they don't have time to listen and asking for my contact info. I still need to observe more about this church and whether I should keep going or not. I also drop prayer requests through an email but never get feedback. I'm disappointed day by day. What do you mean? I just saw the one below there. I just had a glance at it. Somebody said, I just saw something to do with an aggressive deer. You want to meet the fucking the main guy? Have you got any idea how many people go to that church? And you want a one-on-one for how long? 10 minutes? 15? An hour? Just do the maths. It doesn't work out. And you want a prayer? What do you mean? You pray. That's the whole fucking point of it. You pray to God. Don't get fucking him to pray for you. Is that what's... I make a phone call to make a prayer request. What's a prayer request? Oh, what's a prayer request? An idea? Is it something like, could you get Joel to pray for me? You don't need Joel to pray for you. Can you pray for someone? I don't know. I'm not a believer myself, but surely God would he be like that, right? Nobody's praying for this cunt. He's getting it. I'm disappointed day by day. You're drifting away from fucking God day by day and you're trying to drift towards this cunt. He can't save you. Only the power of God can save you, eh? You're looking in the fucking wrong place, eh? You're looking at Earth. Decoy, thanks to sub. Shout liquid like solid snake. I don't know what that is. Is that Metal Gear Solid or something? Or liquid. I got attacked by an aggressive deer in the parking lot. Thankfully, I got out with my life and only minor injuries. Bad area. Tsk, tsk. None of the churchgoers or employees seem to bat an eye. Good thing I have a tough soul. Is this a fucking joke? An aggressive deer. Charlie's got 6 reviews. Charlie, before I move on to Cilla, by the way, or whatever else I'm going to do, we're going to be looking at Charlie's other reviews because I've got a feeling that Charlie will have got attacked by a deer here, 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 here. Damien, before I go and check out Charlie, just want to see, I never went to his church, but I pray, beg your pardon? 1 out of 5, I never went to his church. That's it. Delete. Flag is inappropriate. I never went to his church, but I pray that the real Lord of Kings has a special encounter with him so that Joel can change his life around. I hear this man is a prosperity preacher. If you want to save your soul, which is valuable, then go to a different church like a small one and run from Joel's. If you don't mind, L, the L for Lord when talking about Lord Jesus Christ should be a capital L. Same with like him and his and all that. If you're a Christian and that's what you're into. That lowercase L is going to land you, that's going to give you 10 years in hell. It's optional. It is not optional. It is not optional. Terrible cunt. It is not optional. Imagine you get to the pearly gates and he casts you down and he says it is not optional. Can you imagine that? There you are. I think I've made my point there. The real Lord of Kings. Sing Hosanna to the King of Kings. Let's see, so Charlie, who got attacked by the aggressive deer, has done 6 reviews in total. Oh, hidden reviews. I see. Any photos? No. Ah, you're fucking at it. You're at it, Charlie. Have we watched Cheddar do it? This church is not known for its openness to the homeless during cold weather. I called when I was told it was open, couldn't get through the myriad phone system. The people are known for having too much. They should be taxed. False teachings. You think of the security you must have. Think of the fucking security. The amount of fucking people who must be like that. I need to kill him. God told me. Kind of thing. False. You want to go through this life as grey as possible. Grey. I'm no Joel Osteen. I'm no John Lennon. I'm nae cunt. I'm no here. Inadequate Chris and Blue May, thanks to subs. Have you all had a mirror wank? Of course. Radioactive Ham, Blasted Pinata, thanks to subs. A prayer request is like a blam request, but much more likely to come true. I can't find your sketch where you think the guy keeps looking at you, but he's actually looking at a menu above. Can you help me? It's in the first series. Right, let's pick a random place. I'm going to pick one random place, right, in Scotland. And we'll look at a restaurant and then look at 3 bad reviews. And then I'll move on, right? Is there anything here? Is there anything here? Welcome to Scotland. Got a luscious greener. Luscious. Luscious green. Oh, that rain falling down, mate. Anyway, let's see Melbourne in here. What is Melbourne? Doesn't seem to be in here. What? Why? Why has this place got a fucking name? Because look, you've got Beggs Hill. Beggs Hill. Why not just call this Beggs Hill? Melbourne. Look, Baines Hole. Why is that called Melbourne? Maybe it used to be something. Baines Hole. Am I still in Baines Hole? No, that's shooting to Melbourne now. That's shooting to Melbourne. This is a different jurisdiction. There's nothing there. I mean, is there like something that separates them, like a fucking wee river or something? What is it? Right, come on, give me. What, I've never heard of these. Where are we? Battle Hill, Moss Head, Brideswell, Drumblade, Course, Draft, Ocarney. Look at these places. Milton of Cairnborough. Any restaurants? Any restaurants? What is it? Where'd you come from? A wee place out the way called Auchendown. Auchendown? Keithmore. Are these just names of farms? Does that mean I could name it? Wait a minute. Does that mean I could like buy a farm and go, it's not called Keithmore anymore, it's called Limmytown? Right, where's Nairn? Right, we've got, right, here we go. Right. Aussie's fine dining. Well, we'll let reviews. Salt and vinegar, fish and chips. I knew the ratings would be fucking high for that. You just know it. Oh, I can feel this place. I can feel this place, man. I can feel the heat. Reminds me of Millport. What was I looking for? Salt and vinegar. And it is. 4.7. I'm not going to look at any reviews. I want to look at a fancier place. I'm no. Cafe Nairn. This will be good ratings for everything. Everything will be getting good ratings. Subway, that'll be getting low ratings, won't it? Subway. 3.9, just as I fucking expected. Everything else. Aussie's Fine Dining. 4.7. Royal Bengal. 4.4. Salt and Vinegar, 4.7. Cafe Nairn, 4.6. Subway, 3.9. Bad. Drop me in there. Drop me in. No, I don't like that. I don't like the chains here. It's nowhere near as good quality as the thingy cafe. Where is it? No, look at that. Look. No. No. Reviews. First of all, I'm just going to look at a couple of newest ones. Very good service. 5 out of 5. 5 out of 5. 5 out of 5. How many reviews? 170. It's all looking good. It's looking good. I know, no very good footfall. It's looking good. All the newest, 5 out of 5. Very good. Big Mac? Is this a joke? I went last Tuesday with my 3 children, ex-husband, and decided to order the Big Mac, and I would, without a doubt, say it's been my best Big Mac I've had in my 57 years of existence. The burger bun was toasted to perfect. The burger patty was juicy and succulent. The lettuce crisp, the most refreshing. Right, what's this? Just a piss take. Truly incredible. I could write a critically acclaimed novel about how good it was built. So, well done, KFC. It truly was finger-licking good. Just a joke. Did he just go about doing funny reviews? £100 per person. Aye, they're taking the piss. Nah, we don't like that. We don't like that here on this stream, in this community. Right, lowest rating, please. 11 months ago, a year ago, 4 years ago, 3 years ago, a year ago. Everything's changed within the last year, by the looks of it. Sadly, one of our sandwiches had a dead fly in the salad, which was only spotted luckily as I was picking out some of the jalapenos. We returned the sandwiches and got a refund without any trouble. A bit concerning from a food safety point of view, as the fly must have been in the salad fridge. And what do you think you would have got for it? I don't think you would get ill for a fly. I mean, you could, but it's a drop in the ocean compared to all the other stuff floating about. A bug disease? Like what? If you go cycling, you get about 20 flies in your fucking mouth a minute. Okay, to be honest, I love Subway, quick and simple food. Oh dear. Delivery takes over an hour. Nah, no happy. Talking about a rat in the lettuce. Somebody made a joke. I came in on Monday. The staff was so rude not to thank you on site. Never coming. The older lady was more interested in having a conversation about shoes to the other young girl. Won't be returning. I'll tell. Very hostile service to somebody else. Let's move on. There's Cilla to be watched. Now, if you could just hold on 1 wee second, I need to check to see if my son's okay, because I'm a good dad.
Does that mean I have to have my legs in the air all night?
Well, I don't have a vase, do I?
I'm a really good dad. What's that? What is that? What's going on there? What's that there? People testing what's blocked. Blacklisted, what's I? SDL and Snowblow, Jamie got 25 thanks for subs. Ram this prime down your dick pipe. Thanks. Thank you. Chrissy and Elevators Fairtale thanks for subs. Which one of your sketches had the guy saying you're gonna die tonight? I used to quote it all the time. It's that one. It's that one. Not even asking what episode it's in. What sketch is the one where in the sketch it does that? It's that fucking one. It's the one with the shapes. Pick a colour or pick a shape. Maybe pick a number as well. Thank you very much. You're very welcome, Elevators, Hoofy Horse and Tommy. Neurons, thanks to Subs and Bits. Chatter all baby Christians. Aye, when you're ready to step up a wee gear. By all means, go to that one. The Rise of the Woodland Off-Gridders. Fucking wanks. Right, where am I? Who's ready for? Here we go. Surprise. Surprise. What have we got? What have we got? This one, I'd like one with adverts, that'd be nice. What one's this? It's the one with Basil at the end. This is the one with Basil at the end. Oh, exciting stuff. Everybody, I've managed to obtain the masters. I've managed to obtain the tapes. Here we are. Basil had maybe one or two too many miniatures on the flight air. Prednad, thanks for sub. Brownie, thanks for sub. Bolt versus Ball, who wins in a battle with the Michaels? Michael Ball. Are both naked, no weapons? Fucking Michael Ball. Michael Ball's sort of bigger. Michael Bolton looks old as fuck. Frail. He looks frail. I think today Cilla's going to be a cracker. What are we talking about there? I think Basil... The thing is, if you have a drink on a flight, it's hard to tell if you're getting wrecked because you rarely need to get up unless you're going to the fucking toilet. You're just sitting there getting steaming. You're not really having to talk a lot. Hard to... I remember once, what fucking pub was in it? It's fucking steaming. I wrote about it before and I've spoken about it before that when I was out steaming one night. And then I went back to my office and I kept drinking there by myself. Got up the next day. Lynn was like, oh, did you go back to the office or whatever? I can't quite remember. And then made my way back slowly, like on a Sunday or something, or a Saturday. Back to the house, but went and got a drink here and a drink there and a drink there and a drink here. And... where the fuck is it? And I went into a few pubs. I was staying in Brighton at the time. I went into a few pubs there. I was fucking steaming. So when I had spoken before, I had fucking... Where was it? Was it here? It was there, wasn't it? Aye, there. That there. Lynn said... If I remember correctly, is that the right way? Has this changed? Is it? What the fuck is that? Am I looking the wrong way here? Wait a minute. What? How about this? 2020? Oh, I don't remember that. Here, wait a minute. Were these no shops? Oh, wait. Come on here. And then... these are the shops. The shop there. But that's the fucking shops. That's the shops. Lynn said she... I go back in time now. No, maybe there was fuck all there. More dates. There we are. Aye, there you go. They knocked that down. Oh well. Oh, fuck off. Hey, 10:30. Hey! Yay! You're in fucking Brighton. You don't do that in fucking Brighton. You do that or that. These fucking wanks, man. Right. So angry, I know, I do apologise. Lynn says, I'm coming back, and then I ended up going for pub to pub to pub, and then she went to the shops about here, and I think, what was it? I don't know if she said, I was there at the bandstand. I went in about, I don't know, 2 o'clock in the afternoon or something on a Saturday or a Sunday, got a curry for, where was it? Don't know where I got a curry for. I thought, was there no place there? There's no place. I thought that was a restaurant there. I don't know. I got a curry and I fucking ate it there. Scooping the curry with the lid. Lynn said she saw somebody kind of like, I don't know if she said, I think what she said was, what definitely happened was she was walking this way to the shops and saw a steaming guy kind of walking in her direction. I don't know if she'd spotted this steaming guy earlier, but walking in her direction, steaming. And it was me and I didn't even see her, didn't even recognise her. I think. Something like that. She just kind of walked away. She could have went like that. Brian, what are you doing? And she just sort of ignored us or whatever. I was fucking wrecked. About 2 o'clock or something. And I was in... well, when did I realise I was fucking... I think these are all like Rangers pubs. It wasn't there. It was... I'd walked past them before, but I'd never been in. I think it was that one. It might have been that one I went into. I went, fuck it, I'm going in there, man. Might have been that one. I don't know. But I remember I was in there. The idea was, I've got up, I went back to the office, drinking during the night, went to sleep, like on the flare, in the office, and then I woke up, and then left, and I thought, I'll get a wee pint before I go up the road. And another pint, another pint, and I was like, just ended up like getting the train and then getting off and then ready to walk up the road and then fuck it, may as well pop in here, get another wee pint. And that was me fucking drunk again. And I think I was in there and I remember, I didn't realise how fucking drunk I was until I was putting money in a machine, you know, a puggy, a fruit machine, and a guy, some old guy kind of said something to us, kind of saying no, something, and I think I went like that. And I think the guy was like that. I didn't realise, I couldn't, see when I spoke, it was, I couldn't, Yet somehow I could order a fucking pint. Can I have a pint? Can I have a pint? But I couldn't string together thoughts and words. Best feeling ever. Probably was at the time, aye. And then headed up the road, went in the house, spewed up, I think. Right up the fucking next to the bath. I think I spewed up the toilet wall. Great days. So maybe that's what happened with Basil on the flight air. You don't realise how drunk you are until you have to speak. You're not really speaking much on a flight. Especially if he travelled there himself. Mark Feiler, thanks to sub. Loch Lomond, first trip to Scotland. What would be your recommendation for nearby places to check out? I don't know. I don't know that well. I've been to it, cycled to it. Had a pal who used to work there. I don't know. Loch Lomond, really. I don't know what else is there. Dock Bay Marina? I don't know. I'm going to come across a dickhead here, but I just Google it. I don't know what you're into. Restaurants? Google restaurants. Wee cafe? Or anything else? I would honestly just look at where you're staying and just sort of zoom in and see what's there. TripAdvisor, Loch Lomond, that kind of thing. Me personally, I don't know it that well. And if I did know it personally, I've got a wee place that I like. It would probably be quite personal to me and doesn't really mean much to other cunts for the same reason. So it wouldn't really work. It doesn't work. Asking for recommendations, it doesn't work. Neil and Reddick, thanks to subs. I don't think I played Hypnospace Outlaw. I might have been that, or I might have been that other thing that's kind of similar or sounds the same. Ewan, thanks to sub. Would you ever consider going back to Skyrim and playing survival mode? No. I think that's that done now. That's that done. Everybody, I've managed to obtain the master tapes. Dan Katz, thanks to the sub.
This is your LIMMY'S TV. This is your Sunday night. And here is Cilla. Cilla Black with Cilla's Surprise Surprise.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Cilla Black.
It's too red. Everything's red and it's all red. Kind of orangey. You know, it's red, and this is the thing with Cilla, and I noticed this with her yellow suit. The yellow suit where a kind of top underneath it was the same kind of shade of yellow with black. It's all shades of the same colour. Sometimes if I go out and I'm wearing, like the other day, I think I had green shorts on, and I was wearing a greenish t-shirt, and I thought, don't you kind of do that? It looks like you've tried to, you're pure proud of yourself for wearing a coordinated green fucking safari suit. Deliberately wear something that doesn't go with it. And it looks like, look, she's dressed for the hair. That's exact same colour for this distance. It's exact same shade. And the shoes. I wonder, oh, I see ye. There she is. There's Basil's, what is that again? Sister. Right there. She's sitting there all crouched in, look. She doesn't realise she's going to have to get up. She's going to be greeting her eyes out by the end of this project. She knows. Look, she's like, yes. Oh, wait.
Thank you. Hello.
Look. She's looking like, here we go. What? Here we go. This is it. Rake, and thanks to the sub. Wonder how many of these they filmed in a day. Normally be like game shows and things like that, they get like two or three done in a day. It's just that these go on for quite a while.
Hello and welcome to Surprise Surprise. Now here in our audience are a lot of people who are gonna get a...
Look at this. Why is that? Why have they done... Why has this got like bars here? But that Disney, why has this got the kind of... roller coaster style thing, because it makes sense if they're kind of like infernal or whatever, and there's bars down there. You've got them there, then there. It's not like you're seeing people like, well, you need the bars there, it kind of helps them get up, because what about them behind? Is it just like a breaker higher up, is it? Oh, aye, so it is. Aye, because their feet are practically at the arse, their feet are at their shoulders, aye, you're right. Aye, they can't really trip up and go. Aye. You're right. You're absolutely right. It could be a horrific accident.
Big sup-
I would like to see what led to bars getting put up.
Prize before the night's over. So let's see if I can find my first unsuspecting guest. Where are you? I'm coming to get you out there. Oh, look at this, they're all terrified. Absolutely.
Look at the cameras move, look.
Oh, look at this, they're all terrified.
Run! Absolutely. How many cameras are there? One, two, three, four, five cameras. Oh, wait a minute, is that one there as well?
Absolutely.
Is that one there as well, right in there? Five.
Absolutely. To get you out there. Oh, look at this, they're all terrified. Absolutely terrified. But it's not as bad as all that. What's your name, sweetheart?
Helen.
Oh, that was quick. You frightened me there. Hello, Helen.
Hello, Cilla.
Is this your lovely husband here?
It is.
What's your name?
Vince.
Hello.
Any particular reason when you're going out, she didn't go, oh, you got a bit sticking up at the back there? Like make an arse of himself? Maybe an argument before they left. He said something kind of smart arse, and then she would usually say, there's a bit sticking up. She just thought, you know what, fuck him. Let him make an absolute fucking tit of himself. Real Atomic Jeep. And Tune thinks the subs. Hello to you and Heather.
Vince. Now a little birdie tells me that you're still celebrating your 13th wedding anniversary. Is that right?
That's right. Yes.
Oh, well, surprise, surprise. It could be unlucky for some, but it's very lucky for you too, because I've got a special surprise bottle of champagne just for you both. Congratulations, Helen. Thank you. Wonderful.
Right, can you go now, Cilla? Can you go now?
Well, now, Helen, you're a nurse, aren't you?
Oh, fuck.
Yes. I know this because your great friend Neris told me all about you. Yeah. Yes. How long have you been a nurse?
24 years.
5. You're in fucking trouble, you. You're in fucking trouble, you.
Yeah. All about you.
Look. Do you know what I just thought?
Yeah.
I fucking knew this was something to do with...
I know this because your great friend Neris told me all about...
It is.
About you?
That's anger.
Yeah. Yes.
Uh-huh.
How long have you been?
She's like, oh, she's stuck her in.
Yes.
24 years.
There's something going on in that face there. That's not just, I've done a good thing. This is, aye, that'll fucking learn you. That'll fucking learn you.
24 years. Now, can you remember a certain story about 16 years ago when you were in an army ambulance and a pregnant lady was in that ambulance? Mm-hmm. Can you remember what happened?
Lady had a baby in the back of the ambulance.
Yes. You had to deliver it.
That's right.
And, well, you saved that baby's life, didn't you?
Army?
Mm-hmm. Because it was in a lot of distress. What was wrong with the baby?
Very premature.
Yes. And it had the
umbilical cord around its neck.
And you had to do all that?
That's right.
Had you ever delivered a baby before?
No.
Well, your friend Neris told me that you've often wondered whatever happened to that little baby boy.
That's right.
Well, surprise, surprise, Helen. That baby boy's life, who you saved, Stanley Goodall, he's been sitting next to you since before the show started. Say hello to that baby boy.
I thought that was the win.
Isn't that gorgeous? Oh, yes. What a lovely way to start the show. Enjoy the rest of your anniversary. Congratulations. Well done, Stanley. God bless you.
She's like, my God. Oh, my God. Enjoy the show.
Stanley Goodall. He's been sitting next to you since before the show started. Say hello to that baby boy. Isn't that gorgeous? Oh, yes. What a lovely way to start the show.
What was that? What was that? And then him.
Isn't that gorgeous?
Is it gorgeous? Gorgeous?
Isn't that gorgeous?
Is that what she's saying? Grown. Grown. You're grown. Grown!
Isn't that gorgeous?
And Cilla says gorgeous. Does she say like, oh, isn't that gorgeous?
Isn't that gorgeous?
Isn't that gorgeous? That, right. Isn't that gorgeous? A gorgeous situation. Isn't that just lovely? Like that?
Oh, yes. What a lovely way to start the show. Enjoy the rest of your anniversary. Congratulations. Well done, Stanley. God bless you.
Hi, right. Okay. All right, hi. God. Right.
Well, earlier today, Mrs. Jane...
Could I be moved? No. It's just, I just feel that I kind of got to go like that for like the night. How long is this going to be lasting for? 2 hours. Two. I thought the programme would last for about an hour. It does, but you know, we film it for an hour, we've got to do retakes and there's a bit of a break and, right, it's just, I've got to be like that. That was good, that bit. When to kind of feel obliged to, you know, include them in anything that I say. Like, you know, if I'm saying something to my pal here, I've got to go like, oh, it's good, isn't it? I was just saying it's good, isn't it? Aye. What are we going to do after this? What are you doing after this? You don't have to come with me if you don't want, but, you know, you're invited if you don't, if like that. Can we just sort of get moved away now and then we'll be pen pals or some shit like that? I just feel it's like saying, right, see you later, and then we're both walking the same fucking way for 10 minutes after it. I don't like Rory. Sam thinks the subs. Cilla pushed in front of my nan in the post office once. And when my nan confronted her, Cilla chinned her. Frog playing a banjo and Adam. Vashitari thinks the subs and bits. Thank you very much. W. Parry and Giorgio. Jimmy Thickness thinks the subs. Thank you very much, your resub surprise. Psycho Paul thinks the sub. There's no many haters of Cilla. Summer of Cilla.
Harris was part of a group touring the studio.
Was that?
Well, earlier today, Mrs. Jane Harris was part of a group touring the studios when I unexpectedly bumped into her.
Oh, that's right.
I'm sorry.
Engelbert.
I'm supposed to be rehearsing here today. I'm sorry, I've interrupted. Could you stand up, please? Now that I'm here, I may as well have a chat to you. Can both of you stand up?
Oh, gosh.
What's your name, sweetheart?
Jane.
Jane. Hello, Jane.
Hello, Cilla.
Who's your friend?
Carol. My sister, Carol.
Hello, sister, Carol. Cilla.
Nice to meet you.
Jane.
Hello.
Hello, Cilla. Who's your friend?
Carol.
My sister, Carol. Hello,
Carol. Nice to meet you.
Well, isn't this a surprise, then?
Gosh.
Have you got tickets for tonight's show, by the way?
No. We don't know what we're seeing.
She's got the eyes that be good for sort of like a bit of gossip or something like that, where you would say to her, really? And she'd go like that. And then she did. They went in there for an hour. It's that. Yep. Exactly.
Supposed to be in the audience
on a tour.
Oh.
Yeah. What? Yeah.
What a shame. Because you know the series has been going ever so well. We've had some smashing people on. We've had Frankie Vaughan on. We've had Shane Ritchie on.
I know.
And pretty soon we're going to have Engelbert Humperdinck on.
Oh, you don't mean it.
A little twinkle came to the eye there, Jane. Do you like Engelbert Humperdinck?
I love him. I love him.
Have you ever been to one of his concerts?
I've been to three altogether.
Three? Three?
Yeah.
Have you ever met him, though, at one of these concerts?
I kissed him, actually, but only for a second or two, and then I was in the audience.
How did you get to kiss him if you were in the audience?
I just walked down the steps and talked to him a minute or two and gave him some chocolates and then he kissed me.
He did? Oh, what a shame.
Yeah.
He will be here soon, he will. And much sooner than you think.
Oh, no.
Because surprise, surprise, here he is, the man himself, your idol.
Ben Street thinks it's
Engelbert Humperdinck. Come in, Eng.
Surprise, surprise.
Yes. Yes.
Lovely.
I think
she's suitably surprised.
I brought the chocolates for you. One good turn deserves another. Here it is.
Thank you.
Don't eat too many.
And there's something else.
Gorgeous guy, man. Gorgeous guy. Lovely lips. Tan. Hair. Dress sense. And his mid-Atlantic accent. He's got a lot, man.
Well,
you know, we lied about the tickets. Yes.
We have two tickets for you.
Oh.
We have two tickets. Is that okay?
It's wonderful.
And not only that, Engelbert's going to sing a song just for you from his brand new album.
Oh, I don't believe this is happening.
And I tell you who you've got to thank for this. Yes, right, your Carol over. Ah, oh, isn't that lovely?
Thank you. Why did they change his name? It's something like he had a brother or something called, or family called the Dorsey Band or Jimmy Dorsey or something. Engelbert Humperdinck. Like he was known by one name. Arnold George Dorsey. Started his performance in the late 50s under the name Jerry Dorsey. Later adopted the name of German composer Engelbert Humperdinck. Who was a composer who died in 1921. That's weird, that, isn't it? That's weird, that, isn't it? You're not going like that. Well, I got the name Engelbert for him, and I got the name Humperdinck for this other person, you know, like Elton John. The whole name, and no even for, like, what would that have been, like, somebody who died just 30 years before, 40 years before? whole name. And what a name to change to go for Jerry Dorsey. What you call, I've changed my name. What you going for now? It's not like what's David Bowie's real name again? What's his son called again? Jones, what Jones? David Jones. It's not like going for David Jones to David Bowie. Jones to Bowie. And by the way, I say Bowie, right? I don't say Bowie. Snrub, thanks for the sub. The live footage of him kissing women at his concerts is pretty awful. I've seen it. It's not as awful as you say. Engelbert. Live kissing. What is it?
Or, come on, little girl, with the yellow, come on. It's heavy.
Come on, little
How
girl.
How you doing?
Oh, nice. Remember, I've played this before. right away, I'm regretting saying, "Oh, it's not that bad." Come on, little girl, and then she gets up. Oh, nice. I remember playing this before on the stream, and where's he fair again? Somebody said Leicester. He's fair Leicester, and he went into like Las Vegas and. He's got the whole fucking tan and all that, and
whoa!
And now he's got the I don't know what he was like before, but now he's got this whole a sort of dafty playboy sort of laughing guy. Nice. Like he doesn't take getting serious, and he's just gone about and he's fucking, kind of Beavis and Butthead. Like, I sort of giggly and I sort of that kind of humble. If that's not right word to use. Like, I'm just. Oh, I don't really know. I don't really think. Oh, I don't know. I'm just here for a laugh. Release me. This is his breakthrough. This is the one. This was the hit. I had a greatest hits album by him. Loved it. Went to see him live. He didn't hit some of the high notes. Older. He's not this guy.
Sit yourself on this little cross, would you?
The car, please.
Could you sit down, please? Yeah. That's right, on your... you can't see that, you're on TV. Okay, I'm good. I have one more lady. You want to help me out, darling? Come on. There we go. I'll help you. Sit
yourself
on
this little car. How fucking tight that must be fucking yeah. Fake package. What fucking package?
The dress well.
That fucking action, man.
Together. Okay, good. Remember where you are. Start the... Oh, you have to sit flat. That's fine.
I'd get to be there, man. Well, I'd get to be on, man.
You make my knees kneel as they please. Honey, won't you kiss me again? Give me a little kiss.
Lucky, 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 lucky lady, man. Lucky lady, man. Look at this, look. Look at this with a big fucking crucifix and all that. Look, who does he? Look at this. Who the fuck do you think you are? The thing is, it's hard to say, oh, he's copying somebody. That look was about at the time. That kind of, it's kind of Burt Reynolds, isn't it? This is in the 70s, this is 80s. You know what? I don't know. Actually, see, cutting away there actually made it feel worse. Like, you know, like something in the news and something's about to happen and we have stopped the footage there because it's too distressing. You know, that kind of thing, like cut away. You know, like somebody running up, somebody's lying on the ground and somebody runs up to boot them and it cuts away and you're like, oh! That's what? Just fucking show me. At least I can get used to it. Bobo and Rusty Ham thinks the subs. Prediction for AI. Wait to see in 5 years for now. It's just going to be like everywhere. Jay Weir, Lennox Face. Thanks for subs. Let me get desensitized.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Telly thinks the sub.
Here with a song from his brand new album. Engelbert Humperdinck.
Why are you laughing? Do you not take his name seriously? Now I shout it. Secret Love, Doris Day, Plummet Gin. Honestly, I was at his concert, Royal Concert Hall, maybe 20 years ago, maybe 15 years ago. Was it when we go back? About 15 years ago, I think. It's maybe 16 years ago. He's all older. Wait. No, maybe 20. Because I like him. I had the Greatest Hits album that I sort of played as a half sort of joke while in work, but I genuinely liked it. I went to see him. And all these at the end, all these women rushed down to the front, like giving them things and all that, and like they rushed down to the front. I was like up at this kind of upstairs bit to the side. They rushed down to the front to like give them things and, you know, speak to him, and he's like, hey, and then away he went. Did you rush in too? I was upstairs. Just how wonderful. Next. Oh, what a professional. I see that again. That was the wrong note there, Engelbert. That was right. Golden! He was off. You know, a few people said flat. I don't get that. I don't know why people use that as a word meaning you didn't quite hit the right note. Flat. It makes sense if you're talking, but you know how you've got, like, say, D-flat and D-sharp? So you could say, well, it sounded like you're meant to hit a D, but in fact it was more like a D-flat. It was like doing a semitone. Aye, like pitchy. And there is no way that when people go, I was a bit flat, they knew you were slightly lower than what you should have been, rather than slightly higher than you should have been. There's no way people can notice that. Sharp is an option? No. I've never heard anybody go, I thought your singing was very sharp, was a bit sharp. That sounds like you mean they were singing like that. Kind of, you know, like kind of, ah, yeah, hurts your eardrums. Donk, and Stephen thinks the subs. What a horrible thing to say about him. An open door, my heart's an open door. Yeah, a few notes here. And my secret love's no secret anymore. Is he your idol? No, but I used to listen to things like it's hard not to Oh, I like this. Wait a minute. No, that's that ruins it.
Tell me when will you be mine? Tell me quando, quando, quando. We can share a love divine.
There you are.
Please don't make me wait again.
When will you think it's like that? But that guy, that troll song guy. So I get that one. He's singing, look.
Tell me when.
I think quando means when. There's a good bit at the end of the song because he goes like that. When?
Oh my darling, tell me when.
Here it comes. When? A nice ending to a song, no quite as good as the ending or Don't Get Around Much Anymore by Nat King Cole. Sings of it, don't get around much anymore.
Heard they crowded the floor. Couldn't bear it without you. Don't get around much anymore.
I used to play this in the office and had a right good laugh with Donnie, who's real, by the way. Because, see, at the end he sings, don't get around much anymore. But, and then, I've played this before, I've talked about this before on the stream, but...
Without you.
Listen.
Don't get around much anymore.
And it's like a wee sound at the end. It sounds like... Ah. Or does it? Does he no get around much anymore? Was the whole thing a lie? Listen. Ah. It's got a wee twist.
Yeah.
That's not what the lyrics are about, by the way. The lyrics, if you hear the song, the lyrics are nearly like he's pretending. No, it's just that wee bit then just sounds like wait a minute, I was just conned. You know, like you reach into your pocket for that thing the guy just gave you and where is it?
About you. Don't get around much anymore.
Ah, maybe he's talking shite. Maybe he's talking shite. Tom thinks the sub. I'm very proud. If I'd been born my first sub, but oh, aye. Henners and Lar thinks the subs and bits. People with perfect pitch, deaf hear if it's flat or sharp, by the way. And how many people know if that note's a wee bit low or a wee bit high? Nae cunt knows a fucking thing, especially no one here. Get on, mate. Oh, thank you. Thank you. That was nice. Let me just check. Hold on. Oh, there she is. She should be there on the couch. Like the Michael Ball fan. Daniel. That's how you're having a shower now. Daniel. 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 Brushing your... I think he's brushing his teeth because he's like, Lumsden and Kilted Mackay thinks the subs. Going to be in Glasgow for a couple of days for a wedding. Any suggestions for places to go? No. And the reason is, look, I'll show you. Here's a place, Alec. I've not been for a wee while. I've not been for like a month or two.
Dad, what is it?
And you having a shower?
I haven't had a shower.
All right. Right. Go have a drink of water.
I've had a drink of water there.
All right, in. Right. A place that I like to go to. I've not been for a while. But times? What do you mean? There. We tea room. Nice food, nice cakes. Sort of place it's that plays like Radio 2 or Smooth FM. Quite a few old people in. That's my cup of tea. Pun not intended. Might not be yours though. Monk thinks the sub. I have seen him and he's... I always thought he was American, but this Spook and Slither guy, yeah. Turns out it's the English and lasted for about 3 months.
Oh, that was absolutely marvellous. You know, he's been a secret love of us all for ages, hasn't he, girls?
Yes!
Oh, but right now, I feel a phone call coming on.
Oh.
And not too far away from here, a Carol
Engelbert, you can go now.
Is being pampered in a health studio. Oh, and look, there she is. She's got a face pack on. It's worse, though. She could have been having a body massage. I think I'll just give her a ring. Hang on. Well, she looks ever so relaxed, doesn't she?
Good evening, Liverpool Health Club. It's Anna speaking. How can I help?
Well, hello, love. You can help me. Could I speak to Carol Goodchild, please?
Right, so if you can hold the line, please.
I'm holding.
There's a phone call for Mrs. Goodchild, Emma.
Lovely, thank you. Is a telephone call for you?
Spitefully arrogant face, well said.
Yeah, let me take those off for you.
Passive aggressive eye. Just mocking everybody.
Hello?
Hello?
Is that you, Carol?
Yes.
Well, surprise, surprise, it's Cilla here.
This looks like a genuine one, by the way. this looks like a genuine surprise, like borderline traumatic. Like sitting up for a wee second, like, pardon? But camera coming in. This is a joke. Oh, what?
Yes.
Uh huh.
Surprise, surprise, it's Cilla here.
Look at her sitting up, you know, eyes moving. You know, that way she's like, eyes moving a bit like, what could this be? Searching the brain. What could this possibly be? Instead of, here we go, here's the phone call I've been waiting for.
Pardon?
And then that.
This is a joke.
I said surprise.
She's like, you can't. No, please don't. No. No, no, don't do this. Don't do this. This is probably why, well, a lot of the ones you can tell that they already know, because there's some sort of fucking aftercare. And they've discovered through their research that there's going to be a, you know, what you call it in America, I don't know if you call it here, a class action sort of thing, where multiple victims are going to come together and go, we are fucking traumatised. It might sound like a joke if you actually, like, say it in a fucking tabloid, or we're traumatised with surprise, surprise, but if you're put in that position, you don't know when the next surprise is going to come. What, you think people are going to give you another surprise, surprise? That's not the point. It changes the way you think about the world. You don't know, you can't trust anything anymore. It's strange, you have to have it happen to you to know what I'm talking about. But I want 5 million. Family barbecue, thanks to sub. Going to London for a stag do tomorrow for my pal Lee. Could call him a baldy wank for me, please? And you've spelt it B-A-U-L-D-Y. Now that is actually how you say baldy. B-A-L-D. You don't need to say the U. Baldy is actually how it's pronounced. It's not like old. You're old cunt. You're meant to say old. But I say old. So it's A-U. You actually pronounce it that way. You don't need to do the stick the U in. So he's a baldy wank and you're a prick. RK Mud, thanks to subs. No, enjoy the stag do, by the way. Mr. Mundafarkas once appeared, surprise, surprise, got to meet Ultimate Chaos. Oh, really? If you could find that on YouTube now, you'd probably just make it up.
I said surprise, surprise, it's really me, it's Cilla here. And Carol, I have to say that...
Oh, dear. She's like, I'm not really enjoying this.
Surprise.
Look, smiling.
It's really me, it's Cilla here.
Smile, right? And then?
And Carol, I have...
Nope, look at the face, relax. She's like, and then... Mm-hmm. Sorry, can you speak? Can you speak slowly because some of this isn't going in?
To say there are millions of people looking at you right now with your face back on.
Right. She's having a laugh about it now. Because sometimes the best way to put somebody at ease is to actually tell them the worst possible thing. Makes them see the funny side. So just to let you know, you are fucked. It's ruined. Oh, yeah. It allows people to have a... Ah, you're fucking right. See, you start going... You say to somebody, it's not that bad. Fucks with the head. Just go, it's fucked. Because you can just relax now. Part of your brain switches off. Like, oh, that's actually a relief. I don't have to work out, is this fucked? Is it no fucked? How can I get out of this? It's fucked. We're all looking at you. We cannot see you with the face pack on. But it's done. You can just go, all right, that's me broken. I'm broken down. I've got nothing to lose. I feel light. I feel weightless. What now? What now?
All right, sweetheart.
Yes.
There you go, see? It works.
Well, at least they can't see you blushing with that face pack on, can they? Well, now, Cal, I happen to know that you're a very big fan of our show. Is that right?
Yes.
Ah, well, that's lovely. Now, Carol, you're having all this beauty treatment there. You must be going somewhere...
She reminds me of the Queen.
Now, Carol...
R.I.P. God bless.
You're having all this beauty treatment there. You must be going somewhere special tonight. Where are you going, Chuck?
I don't know. It's a surprise.
Well, it certainly is a surprise. Because when you finished your beauty treatment, there is certainly...
Hold on. What is it with Cilla's teeth? Are they long? Cilla was known for her teeth. What are her teeth actually doing? Are they coming out? Are they coming out? Are they kind of narrow? Is it like a narrow set of teeth? And then see how the bottom teeth look wider? See how you can see these teeth here? At the bottom, I don't know if you can see on the phone. But at the bottom there, it's like the bottom set of teeth are kind of like wide, they go kind of wider in there. And the top set are kind of narrower. Like she could fit all the top teeth inside that, if it wasn't for... I mean, if I was Da Vinci and I'm drawing the anatomy, like the angles and the proportion, what am I looking at there? What is this?
It's a surprise.
Like that. They must come out. She's smiling and these teeth are almost beyond the bottom lip. Did she have a sort of like Freddie Mercury kind of teeth come out? Maybe cause a, what do you call it? A dummy?
Because when you've finished your beauty treatment, there is a car waiting outside to bring you to our studios.
Where's she going?
Where are you going?
Too busy thinking about teeth.
No, it's a surprise.
Well, it certainly is a surprise. Because when you've finished your beauty treatment, there is a car waiting outside to bring you to our studio.
Oh, right. And see the Bee Gees, their teeth. Bee Gees teeth. What was it with their teeth? What are we looking at when we look at the Bee Gees teeth? Like, what is that? Is it because they're all kind of flat? But are they big teeth? But are they also kind of... Right, you've not got, like, the two front teeth are sort of bigger than the rest. Paid for? No. They were real. A lot of them. Look. Look. Look at fucking Robin there. Simply long teeth. And his teeth look like, I don't know, I can't talk shit because of it. Is it because all you see is teeth and nae gum? You expect to see like a wee bit of the gum? Now, some people have got wee teeth but big gums. Some people it's just all teeth, nae gums. He's got nae lip. That's just because he's kind of smiling a bit there, but he's sort of the same. Actually, What are we looking at? Is it because you never see the gums? Yeah, what's that? Did they get them fixed? Because that tooth there, I can see that tooth. It's a bit different. Did they get his teeth fixed? Veneers 100%. Veneers in they day and that day. They all did. They're no fucking veneers. Wait a minute. No, I think like braces or something. I think braces that sort of brought their teeth. Were BG's teeth real? Rocking his veneers at the age of 76. That doesn't matter. This is pish. He had his teeth replaced around 1996. That doesn't matter. This is all gossipy shite. This is nothing. Right. No. I think it was their teeth. I think it was their teeth, but maybe braces or something to sort of like any gaps in the teeth just to sort of bring the teeth together so they're all kind of perfectly, maybe too perfect. H.E. Yarny, Callie, Amura, thanks for subs. You're very welcome.
How do you feel about that, Carol?
I really don't know what to say. I'm so surprised.
It's a wonder you can say anything with all that stuff on your face, John. But you are coming to see the show, all right?
It's not that much stuff, Cilla.
Yeah, so we'll see you later then to see if the face pack worked. All right.
Yes.
You can go back to relaxing now, Carol. We shall see you later. All right, Chuck?
Thank you.
Give everybody a wave. We're all watching you, millions. Ta-ra, then. Ta-ra.
Okay.
Oh,
that just happened.
Carol doesn't know.
Rock Booper is saying in quotes, millions. Yes, Rock Booper. You don't need to put it in quotes. Actual millions. Millions. And this isn't even like pure, like fucking the heyday of telly. 80s or 70s or something. Only three fucking channels and it's like cannonball, pish, fucking 100 million people watching. Well, it wouldn't be 100 million, but you know what I mean.
Is that we've got a big surprise.
No streaming stuff. Sunday night.
Surprise for her when she...
Watchable sort of programme. This will definitely easily be millions. Easily.
...gets here, but more about that later on. In the meantime, I'm looking for a lady with a South American connection. Well, actually...
Oh! This is a genuine surprise. You can tell. Look at the eyes gone. We see the eyes.
The American connection.
Oh!
Well, actually, it's British Guiana.
Oh!
Surprise, surprise.
No! What?
That later on. In the meantime, I'm looking for a lady with a South American connection.
Bang. For that. To that.
Well, I...
Do you know what they should see? Animators. There's a lot of very good animators with certain Pixar films and all the rest of it. You know what they should do? Fucking analyse all this. And see cunts that try to make CGI... you know, like the CGI Peter Cushing in Rogue One that you all probably think is absolutely perfect and you just kind of see anything fake about it at all because you just don't notice a fucking thing. Helly and Al Grizzle, Pripus, thanks for subs. Taps off. Bob Marty, Animatronic, Obfuscated, thanks for subs. Thank you very much. Mary stopped smoking improv story. I've got to try and remember what the fuck that was. Any advice on how to deal with a toxic manager? I've no. frame them.
Actually, it's British Guiana.
Wait. What?
And yes, surprise, surprise. It's you, Dorothy Beaton. Where are
Get
you, Dorothy?
Get to fuck.
Come on, Dorothy, come and join me on the Cilla sofa.
That's a genuine, real surprise. That's one of the real ones.
I'm looking for a lady with a South American connection. Well, actually, it's British Guiana. And yes, surprise, surprise, it's you, Dorothy Beaton. Where are you, Dorothy? Come on, Dorothy, come and join me on the Cilla sofa.
That's the real deal. That's the real deal there. Name that other shite we saw yesterday. Yes, you, David, someday, they just go like that. Yeah, that's me. Hey, oh my God, that's me. That's me up in. So this is it, yeah.
Sit down there, sweetheart, because it was your gorgeous daughter, Anjani. She told me all about you. Now, can I call you Dot?
Yes, please.
Because everybody else does.
Everybody do. My husband started it off.
Oh, that'd be your lovely husband, Dick, up there, yeah. Yes? Well, let me take you back. Really, let me take you back, although you...
What was that?
Dick up there, yeah. Yes? Well, let me take you back. Really, let me take you
back. Are
you
laughing now?
Dick up there, yeah. Yes?
What's that? Hold on. Off.
Oh, that'd be your lovely husband, Dick, up there, yeah. Yes? Well, let me...
Dick is his... Oh! His name's Dick. I was like, what's with the tittles? I can hear people tittering. Dick up there.
Take you back. Oh, that'd be your lovely husband, Dick, up there, yeah. Yes? Well, let me take you back. Really, let me take you back, although you... Oh.
Then I'm gonna chuckle because Cilla just said Dick up there.
Yeah. Yes?
My husband started it off.
Oh, that'd be your lovely husband, Dick up there, yeah. Yes? Well, let me take you back, really let me take you back all those years ago in British Guiana because you had a very...
They're still laughing. I can hear someone go laugh.
Childhood, didn't you? Because you had... You...
Henry, thanks to sub. Watching Bella work out, any words of motivation for me? You're doing great, you got this. Remember, you've got to lift the most you can. Otherwise, it doesn't work. Got to be damaged. Remember, everybody. Remember, mods. I just saw somebody getting banned. Go in fucking hard with any misfits. Any misfits. I'm just after saying go in hard after she's just said dick up there.
Met and married 30 years ago, a local boy.
All right, wait a minute. Right. Start again, sorry.
In British Guiana, because you had a very tragic childhood, didn't you? Mm-hmm. Because you met and married 30 years ago, a local boy. Yeah. But that marriage didn't work out, did it? Very sad time for you. And in fact, you went just when your Anjani, when she was born, not long after she was born, you got divorced, is that right? It was a terrible time for you because you had to raise this little girl all by yourself. You managed to get a job, which you did, but unfortunately you could only see your daughter at weekends because you had to work away all through the week. But times weren't all that bad because you had a whirlwind romance with your lovely husband sitting up there. He was a British soldier. Yeah. And then your lovely husband brought you and your little daughter back here to Britain. Now, how long have you been here now?
August will be 31 years.
31 years. Well, I know you've never ever forgotten your family back in British Guiana, have you? And since you've been here, a lot of sad news for you, because since you've...
Well, you wouldn't. You wouldn't.
Been living in Britain, your mum has passed away, and also your dear brother, he has died too. Well, it's been a very sad time for you, and last year I know you were terrified when a letter arrived from...
But using new technology, new animatronic technology... this new animatronic technology. And it's very experimental, so you're going to have to sign this form here just before we bring them out.
British Guiana, you were terrified to open it, weren't you?
Yeah.
But in fact, it wasn't bad news, was it? Who was it from? Who was that letter from?
From my niece.
Your niece, Rena?
Yeah.
And she was talking about her mum, your sister, Dana. So you're very happy about that. Yeah. She left your sister's phone number, and you phoned Dana, didn't you?
Yeah.
What was that like?
Talking to my sister after all this time, I just did not know what to say to her.
You didn't? It was very upsetting, was it?
It was very much so.
I suppose you were wondering, I'd love to be there to see her face to face.
30 fucking years? 31 years, was it? No speaking to your sister for 30 years, hardly speaking to you? This is the 90s. No, I know, no.
Well, you don't have to go all the way to British Guiana to see your sister. You haven't seen her for 31 years. We have brought your sister all the way over here to see you. She's here tonight. She really is. Come on, say hello to your sister. Come in, Dana.
Yo, she nearly banged into the fucking...
See you in a couple of minutes. I think that's a wonderful surprise. Look at that.
That's a good one. That's a good one.
She really is. Come on, say hello to your sister.
This is the same episode where Basil bangs into the doorframe. Look.
Come in, Donna.
See? Did you see that? Bang! There's something... It's still Basil's fault. There's something happening there. Look. Bang! What is that?
To your sister. Come in, Donna.
So, look. See that? Bang.
Come in, Donna.
I mean, I'm getting it right, I know. She's not just a step. No, that's a nudge.
Come in, Donna.
She moves around it, no bang. I don't think so. No. That, no. She doesn't just move around it. She didn't touch it, she did. She avoids it. No, she went like that. It was quite a quick movement. It doesn't quite match the rest of the walk. Look, let's see how she's walking. Oh, wait. I think she sort of leans on her left leg a bit, you know, so she sort of goes to the side. It could have been that.
Come in, Donna.
I see. It's just her manner of walking. She didn't bump into it. This is bad for Basil, by the way. This is looking bad for Basil.
I think we better take a break there. See you in a couple of minutes. I think that's a wonderful surprise. Look at that.
That's a good one. Right, so then we go to this. See, I've obtained the master tapes, everybody, through my connections. Blue Jay, thanks for the sub. I have obtained the masters through my connections. Now, I can tell you right now, I need to leave at 1:30, by the way, the usual time, but I need to leave pretty much on the fucking dot. Lynn's not here. Daniel's off school, obviously, so I kind of just go, fuck it, 5 hours, five, you know, something like that. So we need to get through this.
Hello and welcome back. Well, I'm on the prowl again. Hello, hello, hello. Hello. What's your name, sweetheart?
Phyllis.
Well, hello, Phyllis. Hello. Now, I was just thinking, you know, I love sport on the telly. Do you like sport on the telly?
No, only snooker.
Well, that's a sport, isn't it, Philip?
You see so much of the others, don't you?
You see so much of the other?
Yes.
And we don't want to see that on the telly, do we, Philip? Well, you do
the
like
argument now.
Snooker.
Yes, I do.
My goodness.
Neil, are we argument?
Well, out of all the snooker players, who's the snooker player you'd like to chalk your cue?
Steve Davis.
Oh, you said that without any hesitation there. Indeed, Steve yes. Davis.
Yes.
Now, is it true, Phyllis, you've actually stayed up all night with the
snooker? Is it all got to do with, I don't know what that would mean, chalk and horse cue, but it's quite a kind of, it's all got these sort of sexual connotations. And you could chalk your cue any day of the week. Is that right, Phyllis? It's got that kind of weight yet.
Been bag on you to watch him on the telly.
Yes.
Yeah, why?
I fucking chalk my cue. Oh.
Well, I hadn't got a video, so if you didn't say up late at night, you didn't see it, did you?
Are you that big a fan of Steve Davis?
Yes, I do.
Have you ever seen
No, are you that? I said, are you that big a fan?
Are you that big a fan of Steve Davis?
Yes, I do.
You do what? You do are big that a fan? You do are that big a fan? Is that what you do? You do are I'm that big?
Have you ever seen him in the flesh?
No.
Well, surprise, surprise, you're going to see him now. Because here he is, your favourite on the telly, 6 times world champion, Steve Davis.
It's only 6 times world champion, Steve Davis. Still ginger, no grey yet. He's no full ginger. He's no full fucking ginger. That's Auburn. That's Auburn. He could get a tan. He could get a tan. He's no true ginger. He's Auburn.
What I thought I'd do as a little sort of surprise and a memento, bring along one of my practice cues for you actually to have and keep. Not that you don't have to play with it, but just to sort of keep it. Peter Chalk, so you can help me through the matches at night time. and afterwards, we're going to sort out some tickets perhaps for next season. And afterwards in the hospitality
perhaps.
Room, we'll just have a drink and a few chats.
Oh, yes, isn't
or a few
lovely?
Drinks and a chat, even.
Are you happy now, Phyllis?
I'm thrilled to be.
Wonderful. I'm so pleased for you. And it's all our big thanks to Steve Davis. Yes. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, Phyllis and Steve. Wonderful.
It's a very working-class sport. Snooker. You might think it's posh, but it's very working-class class sport because it's cheap. Very accessible.
You know, it's a funny thing, but some people have some very strange interests. I mean, take Rachel Watts. She's a
pub game, innit? Well, it's not really. Pool is. Tom Stewart, thanks to sub. Thread Redemption, oh, brilliant.
Obsessed with the office tannoy system, so much so she's forever using it to make announcements. She'll make announcements about anything at the drop of a hat. So I went along to where she works to catch her in the act.
Ah, girl.
Can Mrs. Willis please come to the sales office?
What the fuck are you wearing? You fucking boxing match? It's like a Italian stallion. Rocky Italian stallion. Don't watch, that's the porn thing. Italian stallion robe. Oh, wait a minute. Maybe I've got the wrong colours. It's kind of like that. But instead of yellow and black, it's red and black. What did Clubber Lang robe? No, he's black and white. Is that a boxing one, though?
Willis to the sales office.
Mrs. Willis? That's me. Morning, everyone. Morning.
My God, it's Cilla.
Hello, girls. Morning. Okay, Mrs. Willis. You did. Mrs. Willis has arrived.
Oh, no.
Yes, Rachel, stand up and have a chat with
us. Stand up, you.
Surprise.
Fucking get up. Up.
Surprise. Thank you. Now, all your good mates here tell me all about you, especially Judith and Anne-Marie. And they say that you love making these announcements on the tannoy.
I want you to stop. They want you to stop. Will you stop? Because the next time I come, you already know. You'll be typing away and then everything will just go black.
Yes.
In fact, you volunteer for every announcement.
Yeah.
And you've got a nickname, haven't you?
Yeah.
Tannoy. Tannoy Tracy. What's her name?
What do they call you?
Bing Bong Lady.
Bing Bong Lady. Well, surprise, surprise. I got a surprise for you. Because it might be great.
Oh, they could get Ruth Madoc. They could get Ruth Madoc in again. Because Ruth Madoc, when she was Gladys and Heidi High, we go ding, ding, ding on the xylophone or whatever it was.
No, idea.
They could just fucking get her in for different things and.
Down here. But you've got a burning desire to be the Bing Bong Lady at Heathrow Airport, haven't you?
Bing Bong.
Oh, no!
What?
Airport, haven't you?
That's exactly what you're going to do.
Oh, no! Yes, because we thought you've got a special birthday coming up at the weekend, haven't you?
I have, yeah.
How old are you?
30.
30? Oh, I can't wait to be 30. tell me what it's like. Well, as a special birthday treat, we're taking you off to Heathrow, all right?
Oh, lovely, thank
you. So we're
going
to get your hat and coat. Sorry, girls, it's such a flying visit, but here we go. Oh. Which way to Heathrow?
Let's go.
Well, here we are, Rachel. The big moment has arrived, Chuck. Yes, it has. It's your time to bing bong away. You're looking forward to this?
Yes.
Right, go.
Well, we've got a couple of announcements for her, haven't we, Tracy?
Yes, I have. She'd like to do this announcement.
Oh, look at that. Ooh. Go on.
Okay.
You're on.
Can the last remaining passenger for flight AF813 to Paris please make their way to gate 24? This is the final call for all remaining passengers on flight AF813 to Paris to proceed to boarding gate 24.
Oh, yes! Oh, I hope the microphone wasn't on there. That's wonderful. Well, I've got one more announcement for you to make. Now, this is a personal one.
How do we know for sure that was real? That was very good, perfect. But they may as well. They may as well. It actually, they could have faked it, but there's no reason not to.
This is for a certain Ronald Marchant. Now he's come.
No way they had they wouldn't have. Maybe they wouldn't have had the reverb that handy. It would take more effort to fake it.
To the airport today, because he thinks he's meeting someone. What he doesn't know, surprise, surprise, that certain someone is me,
all
Rachel.
Right.
You've been through that before, haven't you? So there you go.
But see what you heard? I don't think that's how it sounded, because you can hardly make out what they're fucking saying. Regardless, you know, because of the speakers. I think if they recorded it there, it would have sounded like this. It would have been like that. And it would have been like, we're just going to have to fake it, because the real deal is actually sounds shite. Just take what she's saying in the room and we'll just put a reverb on it later on. Beneath the headphones, sinks the bits. Do you reckon they filmed several episodes in one day? 2 max. It just takes that long. I mean, maybe with these wee bits like this, you know, that'll cut down the time because they can film that elsewhere.
Go off, you pop, have a look at that.
Could Mr. Ronald Marchant please make his way to the information desk? Could Mr. Ronald Marchant please make his way to the information desk?
Ronald!
Ah, it's fake.
Ronald Marchant!
Fake.
Ronald Marchant! Surprise, surprise! All right, Ronald.
Now. Fucking train robber. Bank robber. Or one of these cunts that tries to fucking steal his wings for the wife. Like that one and that other fucking surprise, surprise. So you're just ready to run off with your kids to Australia. Is that right?
I suppose you're wondering why I called you like that.
Yeah, I am really. Yeah.
Well, your dear wife...
You're under arrest.
...told me all about you. And she said that you absolutely adore planes. Is that right?
Yes, that's true, yeah.
Now, you were in the Royal Air Force,
right,
weren't
yeah.
you?
But you did never fly.
That's right, that's right, that's right. He's just saying that to anything. I think he just said that's right to something when she hadn't said it.
You wear absolutely adore planes, is that right?
Yes, that's true, yeah.
Now, you were in the Royal Air Force, right, weren't
yeah.
you?
Yeah.
But you did never fly a plane, but you were part of the crew.
No, I never had that luck. I was just in the... In the gun turret.
Well, your wife Joy tells me that you dearly love to fly a plane and love to have lessons.
Yes, that's true.
Well, surprise, surprise, you're going to have your very first one.
Oh, he doesn't like us. Right, 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 aye, right. That's true, that's true. Yeah, right, right. That's true, that's true. It's just spend a bit of time in the gun turret. So just makes you a wee bit, you know, like, hold on. Oh. Aye, just...
Yes, that's true.
Well, surprise, surprise, you're going to have your very first...
Right, he's like that. Right, aye, what? Uh-huh, what's that? Aye. Hold on. You've got to have eyes in the back of your fucking head, because you're in the gun turret. You got... In the plane, you're in the fucking gun turret. Is that what he's saying? Was he in the gun turret on the ground? Or he didn't actually get to fly the plane, he was in the gun turret in the plane?
One.
I want to watch your six.
Well, surprise, surprise, you're going to have your very first one.
My goodness, yeah.
My goodness, right, okay.
And that's not all, that's not all.
Oh, he's perfect for the fucking job. He's perfect for the fucking army. He's just like, I'm listening. Yeah. You know, like a meerkat? The army, what was he in? Air Force. No, I don't. I'm talking about PTSD. I mean, he was like that for the start, which helps. There they are.
What's
That's him.
The most interesting fact about meerkats? Dark markings act like.
There they are.
Here's another interesting fact.
That's him.
Since meerkats are perfect snack size for predators like eagles and jackals, a mob of meerkats, that's actually the name used by naturalists, is a meerkat.
There they are. Hi, uh-huh, yeah, hi, yeah, right.
Yes, that's true.
Well, surprise, surprise, you're going to have your very first one.
Right.
Oh, my goodness.
Right, good, my goodness. Right, hold on. Oh, 4 o'clock.
And that's not all, that's not all. Where are you, Rachel? Rachel, come in here. This is our Bing Bong girl. She was the one that called you. Mr. Ronald Martin.
I thought I got it wrong. It's my Sunday one.
Yes.
They're overlapping the fucking... the surprises.
Rachel, do you remember earlier about calling those last remaining passengers to board that plane to Paris?
Yes.
Well, surprise, surprise, Ron and Rachel, that was us. We're all off to Paris.
Oh.
We're all?
Yes, we are. Yes, we are. So what are we waiting for? Let's go. Say au revoir to Heathrow. We're on our way to Gay Paris. Come on, let's go, Ron. Come on, Rachel.
Better be.
Well, we'll join Rachel and Ron in Paris later on, where the most surprising things happen to them both. But before that, I want to talk to a certain gentleman sitting here in the studio. Now, earlier on, we met Helen, the lovely nurse who saved baby Stanley Goodall's life. And somewhere here in our audience is a man who has cause to be grateful for the care and devotion of another nurse. And yes, surprise, surprise, it's you, Doug Beaumont. I'm talking about you, Doug. Where are you, love? Come down and join me on the Cilla sofa.
That was a mid-level surprise. That was like a genuine surprise. It's me. That's me up now. But it's as if he's told you're going to be getting up at some point. We brought you here for a surprise. You're going to be getting up at some point. But just not going to tell you when. So he's surprised like, Oh, right, that's me then. That's me, right. That's my turn. Rather than, what? Because you can't, when you get to a certain age, it isn't good for you to get that kind of surprise. just fucking topple right there. Right there, men. Fucking Tommy Cooper.
Isn't that a lovely hug?
Aye, all right, fuck's sake.
Just talk amongst yourselves, Rob. Have a sit down there, Doug.
Oh, I noticed his urn. It's a prosthetic urn.
Have a sit down.
I wondered why he was there. It was a prosthetic. That's a bit fucking close. See, even if I brushed my teeth 10 seconds ago, and Listerine the lot, I wouldn't get that close to somebody. Look. Because I'd just be like, if you run out of Listerine, no.
You do. Just talk amongst yourselves, Rob. Have a sit down there, Doug. Well, you asked me straight away.
I can actually look at somebody that close, not because I don't like getting close to people, because I do, but eyesight-wise, slightly long-sighted. I'd have to be like that. Sometimes people come up to me and they say, hello, Limmy, that kind of thing, and they're a wee bit close and I have to sort of go like that. And I hope they know it's an eyesight thing rather than me like that. Fuck off.
Who have I got to blame for this?
Yeah.
It's your dear wife, Paulie. Oh. Yeah, she wrote and tell me all about you. Now, can I take you right the way back to 1942?
Yes.
When you were fighting?
Yes.
For the army?
Yeah.
In North Africa? Ninth, it's on the jacket there, and you're in the desert there.
Yeah.
And you were very severely wounded. In fact, that's where you lost your arm.
Yeah.
Now, you were taken to various hospitals over there, weren't you?
Yes.
Now, this hospital that you finally ended up in was actually staffed by...
Did you kill any Nazis, my man? Did you kill any Nazis, man? See that cunt? He didn't punch a Nazi. He fucking killed him, man. And we're not talking about neo-Nazis or people with Nazi-like views. Actual ones with the fucking armbands, the lot. Members of the actual Nazi party. What would they have been? The soldiers? I kind of, they've all got to kind of all sign up, or, you know, Italian fascists, maybe. North Africa. Nazis were in North Africa, would they know? What was the whole Rommel thing? Aye, right. Jump, die, and Kerset, Graf, Okay. Thanks for subs.
Canadian nurses, is that right?
Not 100%.
No.
They hadn't got enough South Africans at that time. And a contingent of Canadian nursing sisters and staff nurses were sent to South Africa, I believe, after some of them finished up in Italy. I know that one in particular, whose father was the vicar somewhere near Victoria.
Gosh, you've got a good memory Doug.
Well, 1945, she sent me a photograph of her and a little boy who was then 5 months old. And she had married a padre somewhere in Italy.
Really?
But there was another one called...
Stop fucking laughing. He's fucking cunts laughing. Oh, he's kind of gone on a wee bit. Yous would all be fucking... If it wasn't for cunts like him. Fucking ungrateful. See, that's why I would never, I mean, nobody would fucking sign up to get me into a war now. That's why I'd never die for my fucking country. I wouldn't die for any cunt. Because see, 20 years, 30 years down the fucking line, or 50 years down the line, you get cunts laughing at you because you've sort of, you've rambled on a wee bit when talking about the Second World fucking War, when we tried to stop a fucking Nazi hordes.
Gladys, what I was allowed to call a Louis.
Let's sit at him. I think any of these cunts should be able to pick anybody at anybody they want, point them out and go like, get them shot. I think they've earned the right that if anybody laughs at them while they're telling a story regarding the Second World War, when they were fighting and killing Nazis, anybody that goes, ha 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 ha, they're rambling on a bit. They like to go like that. You, up against the wall. TOS. Well, isn't it TOS? There's none of them left. I think they're all dead. 1945 would be the fucking... What are we at? Oh, almost dead. There's a few left. Right. Oh, I don't mean it anyway. Anybody who thinks that's a bit extreme there. And
is because we were very special friends.
So it's not Nazis are people too, I suppose. It's a me, Maria, thinks the sub. Thank you very much for extending your sub there. Oh dear, thanks for the bits. Can we ban Oh Dear, please, for that? No funny wee things about his urn. Thank you very much. Dead. It's all right. We'll get there. We'll work out what's getting said. What is they?
Oh, you were. Yeah. Well, it's Gladys Louise I'm really interested in because she was the one responsible for nursing you indeed back to health.
Yes, because what happened, I put that bad boy on the hospital ship, but it didn't show until I got to South Africa.
Oh,
so I finished up in a medical ward.
But she was ever so good to you, Gladys Louise.
Yes,
to the point am I
going on a bit, everybody? Would you rather that I was dead? That I got, like, killed by a Nazi rather than me killing them? And you've got the Nazis there here. Would you rather that than me going on a wee bit too long? Well, unfortunately, we can't turn back time and you've got the fucking Nazis here, which you seem to fucking prefer. You're going to have to make do with me waffling on a wee bit. I'll fucking never die for any cunt. They're not worth
it. You needlepoint. Is that right?
Well, partly. That was part of it. Occupational therapy.
Yes.
On getting to use my left hand because I originally was right hand.
As long as she's all right with that.
But you actually did a picture, though, didn't you?
I did a picture, yes.
And did you actually weave her initials in this picture?
I did a maple leaf, starting off with green right through to the...
Fuck up! He's just said starting off with green. You're getting tittles in the audience already. Starting off with, he's going to go through like all the colours. He's going to go start off with green and then I went to this colour and that colour. What colours would you prefer? Fucking red, white and black?
Browns, which I gave to Gladys Louise.
You are talking about this lady, this certain nurse, Gladys Louise.
Now
she must be 86.
Because she was 10 years older than me.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Well, you did it.
I'll fucking say this, by the way. I don't know what the fuck he's on about. Who is Gladys?
I admire her so much. And you're very grateful to her. That.
Yeah.
In fact, you named...
Nurse? Was that a nurse? Right. All right. So he lost his arm in the Second World War. There was a nurse there at the time. Is that right? The nurse at the time of him losing his arm.
Daughter
Louise, yes.
Diane Lewis.
Diane Lewis.
Who?
Yes.
And then when Diane had a little daughter herself, she called her daughter, your granddaughter, Nicola Louise.
Louise, that's right.
So you must have been ever so grateful.
Yes.
Well, I know a lot about you. Indeed, you've given me all the information anyway. But on your...
I hate this fucking audience, by the way. Ungrateful bastards, man.
So last night that you spent...
See him? He's laughing it off. He gets it. He's not like that. What? Why are people laughing? You can see the wife's having a wee laugh. Oh, he goes on a bit. I'll step in, though. I'll step in for him. And I'll say, you, out. Just get out. Now, you're not going to get put up against the wall. You're not going to be a martyr. You're not going to get it. No. Just get out. Get out. But see, there's another one. A third world war. And we're having to storm the beaches of Normandy. Again, yous are the first off the fucking boat. Like sandbags. Am I right, everybody? In fact, we're just going to drop you. Just going to drop you out of fucking planes. Just like that. Just splat everywhere. Like. Just as a kind of... Like, fuck with our heads. Like, look what we're willing to do to our end people. We don't give a fuck. And we're coming for yous next.
In Africa, I mean, you did take, to show your appreciation, you did take Gladys Louise to the theatre, didn't you?
Yes.
Right, well, she wrote a certain note on that theatre ticket. Yeah. And I have to get it right. Is this true? Is this what she said? This will be our last meeting until... And then there was a question mark.
Yeah.
Well, surprise, surprise.
No.
I think...
1942 or thereabouts, he lost his arm in the Second World War. And he was nursed, you know, back to health. One of the nurses there was Gladys in North Africa. Or was he taken to Italy or something? No, by then they were still fascist, were they not? South Africa. I'll see you one day. It's got a slight... We could just be like good friends or maybe no even friends, just, oh, I'll see you when I see you. But it sounded like a kind of romance or something, into it? And I'm going to name my wains after. But I could be Gladys with fucking Heidi High.
You can fill in that blank space on your theatre ticket.
But she organised it, the wife. So this is like Michael Ball. This is like the husband who organised the wife meeting Michael Ball. So this is the Gladys gone like that, just... He keeps going on about her. I'm just hoping that this just gets out of his system and then we can just get back to being a family.
Here she is to say hello to you once again, all the way from Canada, Nurse Gladys Louise. Come in, Gladys Louise.
See, she banged into the fucking door as well. See her before. You know how I said, oh, maybe she just moved out the way. I think, no. They're all banging into it.
Come in, Gladys Louise.
Look. Look! There's something at the other side of that that makes them... I think it's because it's reflective. And it's maybe got like a black line or something like these, but kind of a bit further in, that gives you the illusion that that's the edge. There's something... Why do they keep... No, she's using it for leverage. No. Basil at the end of this bumps into it. Her before, who I thought bumped into it and I didn't think did... I knew I'd think she did. And she's doing it. Oh, she's... No, she stepped out the way. No, he... Aye, they're banging into this.
Good though, isn't it?
Yes.
Yes. Put a bit of weight on there.
Oh, that's an answer. Yeah.
A bit discourteous there. He gave her a big hug and he said, "You put a bit of weight on."
Fucking what? What was 42? If 42, 50, oh, it was 53 years ago. Or oh, Cilla's face.
It's courteous there. He gave her a big hug and he said, "You put a bit of weight on."
Well, we all
do.
I'm
not 86, though, Doug.
Pardon?
I'm not 86.
Aren't you?
I'm 83. I'll be
83. Oh.
I think we're going to have a round. While they're having a round, I think we better take a break. Oh, but do join us in a couple of minutes for a trip to Paris.
Oh, okay, that's good. Your next deck, kid. Next. What time is it? Lots to get. Old cunts or shite, says Wondrous and Joyful. Excuse me.
Well, hello and welcome back. Well, we're going to have a bit of a nostalgia now. Have a look at this.
Five.
Thunderbolts, yes.
Four. Three.
Oh, I saw it's the...
Two,
the voice are.
One.
That's right. I remember watching a wee bit of this.
Thunderbirds are go.
Wait a minute. No.
Well, I wonder how many of you remember that. Well, I happen to know there's a someone in our audience for whom that will bring back ecstatic memories for. And yes, surprise, surprise, it's you, James Spencer. Where are you, James? It is you, Chuck. Come down and join me. I want to have words with you.
That looks like a real one. That looks kind of real.
Have you sit down there? My goodness me, James. You love Thunderbirds?
Well, I did, yeah.
You did? Oh.
Everybody told to wear a suit. Everybody's got to wear a fucking suit, man.
Do you recognise these? You will recognise these.
It's got kind of old-fashioned baggy trousers, you know, like he's...
Won't you? Yes. Do you recognise them?
Like he's got to be dancing or something, you know, kind of...
In the bathroom, yes, in the bathroom.
I thought
your
he's...
Your daughter Hayley tells me you won't have a bath without these. Yes, your little rocket... And your little tumbler there, and the soap, which we haven't got there. I must read a very funny letter from your daughter, Hayley. Have you got a minute? Hear what she says about you. Dear... Never mind going like that. I saw that.
I'll do what I want, Cilla. This might be your programme, but your programme's nothing without your guests. So I'll do what I want. That's what I'd say if I was there.
Surprise, surprise. Hi, my name is Hayley Spencer. Would it be possible to send my dad to meet some of the puppets out of Thunderbirds? Because he has got the cup, soap and bath foam. Once he was getting in the bath and he couldn't find his Thunderbird set and he was nearly crying. Is that true?
No.
It is, you little tinker. And I'm not finished yet. There is more. Have a listen to this.
In the end, he found them and he got in the bath and we could hear him say, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Thunderbirds are gone, made the rocket. Meow, splash into the water.
Yes, it is. The little letter writer herself. It's your daughter, Hayley. Come in, Hayley.
No way. Oh. I've not seen her since this morning.
He is a big fan, is he?
Yeah.
Because he's denying it now, Hayley. He's denying... who are your favourite characters? Which one out of all of them do you like, out of Thunderbirds?
Oh, all of them.
You like all of them? But there's certainly... Yes, there's a certain lady, a blonde lady. You like Lady Penelope? Yeah, well, surprise, surprise. You are going to meet the voice of Lady Penelope right now. It's certainly Thunderbirds are go for you, because here she is, Sylvia Anderson. Come in, Sylvia.
Well, has a baggy suit. They trousers, they are like right 19, somebody said 1940s. Look. David Byrne. No, I mean, I know it stopped making sense and the rest of it. Everything, it's no. Look at this, look at the, you know, down here. So there's no reason for the trousers to be that big.
James. Oh my goodness James. Me. Oh, look at
I'm
that.
I'm glad you said Lady Penelope.
Listen to Cilla. When he gave her a kiss. Oh, look at that. Oh, look at that. She's always in with stuff like that, isn't she?
Thank you. James. Oh my goodness James. Me. Oh, look at
I'm
that.
I'm glad you said
Lady Oh, look at that. Oh, look at that. Right in with a kiss. Weren't you? Weren't you in with a kiss? Right in with a kiss. Did you see that, everyone? Oh, he likes her.
Lady Penelope. I was getting very worried there.
No, he likes them all. Lots of goodies there. Now, we all want to close our eyes because you're the voice of Lady Penelope. We want to dream on, don't we? Yes, let's close our eyes and say a few words as Lady Penelope.
Well, it's absolutely fabulous to be here. And Parker sends his regards. And it's absolutely marvellous to be on the Cilla show.
Oh, wonderful. F-A-B. Well, I don't know about you. I've gone into orbit myself. I really have. Thank you very much for surprising our James like that. And thank you, Hayley, for sending the letter. Ladies and gentlemen, James Hayley and indeed Sylvia Anderson, Lady Penelope.
She was like married. Remember, I looked her up. She was married to the maker of Thunderbirds. Is that right? Right. That's right. I wanted to meet the puppets. So Jerry Anderson. Can I? So when do I see the?
Well, it's time to go back and see how Ron and Rachel are getting on in Paris.
Bill Hoover. Sension man.
Wonderful. Lovely. Can I have your cash? Oh, please. Lucia. Yes.
Look here.
Yes. Lucia comes.
Oh,
all right. Good. Very good.
Is this my best,
sir? It is nice. Very nice.
Yeah, it's a gorgeous. Can you only give me one chin, Bruno?
And your name?
Goddamn fucking know the dean.
You know who I am. The dedication. Yes. Wonderful.
Is this for you?
Oh, yes. Let's show the camera. Oh, do you know? This should be
I say you work 1 minute, sir.
This should be in the Louvre. Yes. But not in Paris.
Maybe.
It should be in the Louvre. In
Paris. Joke sort of fucked up. That kind of cut away. And but no, in the Paris. The Louvre. Let's cut away. Look at that, getting the pictures, faces drawn in Paris. Aye.
Oh,
why the heel?
Right.
Sailing
right.
Down the Seine on the thing.
Why the heel?
I mean, I love Paris, don't you?
She just did announcements and work. What's his story again? He was in the army, but he...
Wonderful.
Oh, wait.
So
he never got to fly a plane in the army, in the Air Force or whatever it was, RAF?
No.
He was in the gun turret, so...
No, not really. Didn't join the side. Don't you agree, Ron, all she needs now is an absolutely gorgeous Frenchman, don't you agree? Oh, yes, I think so, yes. You do. Well, shame. What a shame. You haven't got one for me, then?
Ooh, who the fuck is he? Why was the studio audience like that? Ooh, who's he?
Yes, I got one.
Is it just good looking? Is he somebody? Or is he just good looking? Sasha Distel, who's that? Is that really him, or does he look like a footballer called? Sasha. Who's that then? Raindrops keep falling on my head. Was that him who... He had hits with a cover version of Raindrops in 1970, Rich. It reached number 10 in UK charts, right. I see. Raindrops keep falling on my head. Sasha. Where is he?
Beta too big for his bed. Nothing seems to. Raindrops are falling on my head. And just like the guy whose feet are too big for his bed.
He said. I don't remember. Right.
Hello.
Anyway, there he is.
Hello, Cilla.
Hello, Sasha.
So what have you been doing today?
Looking at all the...
I've got 25 minutes, everybody.
Beautiful.
Less. 20, yeah. 22 minutes.
Oh, lovely.
I've taken her everywhere.
Oh, great.
How long have we got left? 15. We're going to have to blitz through this.
Now I know why my name is Gooseberry.
Got a singing bit. Good, we can skip through that.
Oh, that nice, Ron. Shall we leave the two lovebirds
yes,
to it?
Yes, we'll do our own thing.
Yes, let's go to the Eiffel Tower. Au revoir, Sasha.
Au revoir, Sasha.
Rachel. Come on, Ron.
Fucking Cilla trying to get everybody off
well,
paired.
Ron,
I know, I know. Love Eiffel Pulse Tower. Is about 60.
And we've seen the Eiffel Tower.
Wonderful. Yeah,
really. And there's the military school over there, which is quite a coincidence because we were talking about the RAF this morning, your days, your happy days on the Lancaster bomber there.
When we were flying low on our starboard side, I pointed out the skipper. Spanked over a bit, you know. And that was my first sight of Paris.
The skipper, you mean?
The Aussie. Skipper.
And what do you make of this? What do you make of this? Did you know that Hitler was here? Did you know that Hitler was here in Paris? He's up in that building up there and walked down here. Did you know that? And the Nazis were here. And did you know that they didn't manage to make it to Blighty? They didn't manage to make it there. And do you know why? Because of people like him who was in the studio. And do you know what the people in the audience, how they treated him? They laughed at him. They laughed at this guy who fucking literally gave his right fucking arm to kill the fucking Nazis. And these cunts, stuffed, gluttonous, lazy, full of the fucking joys of life, in the audience, laughing. Ha ha ha, he's gone on a bit. He talks a bit too much.
Captain.
He was the captain, Australian.
What was his name?
Bence, Len Bence.
Len Bence.
A real Crocodile Dundee type, yeah.
You were good mates, were you?
Yeah, he used to get us out a lot of sticky parts, you know.
So that's a long time ago, though, that you must have seen his
skipper. Yeah, 44, that was, 1944.
Well, that's over...
That's a long time ago.
That's over 50 years, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
So, and he must have gone back to Australia after the war.
That's why we laugh at you, Lemmy says the boogie man. Exactly. Laugh at a hero. You're laughing at a hero. But just like, as I've said before, like Jesus or God or whatever, I don't quite know. I so love people and my children, that's people, that I have given begat my only self. So that something then died for the, whatchamacallit, so that you are sins, etc. Calico and Neil, legend, horse meat. Thanks to subs. You're welcome to the lot of laughs.
Well, let me stop you there, Ron, because he said he was coming over. We don't have to wait for that reunion. Because surprise, surprise.
Oh! Oh, yeah, brother!
Seen them for 50 years. We've flown them all the way over from Australia to Paris. Here he is, your skipper.
So we get to really get a good look at his face. Look at an old man mask there. Look at an old man mask. Isn't it? Looks like a sort of grandpa for fucking Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Here he is, your skipper. Child, the lady in the face pack has arrived, sir.
Good.
What are we waiting for? Come in, Carol.
See how they keep you going? They keep you hooked. So we're going to see her later, they said at the start. So we're going to see her later and you're like, ah, I kind of go away. Put something else on. No, because see her with the face thing. She's coming in later. Multi-threaded, aye.
Sit down there. Well,
Chai, thanks for the sub. This one's for Cilla. I'll pass it on.
But you look wonderful. You look terrific.
Thank you.
Mind you, I don't know what you looked like before.
Oh, fuck up, Cilla.
Were you suitably surprised?
Very, very surprised.
You
yes.
were. You yes. were. But you took it in all good fun, didn't you?
Yes. I just shook for a long time after.
Oh, well, no, you look wonderful now. And indeed, you've missed a great show. Oh, everybody's been on. You've missed Steve Davis. He's been on. Surprising Phyllis.
Who?
You've also missed Engelbert Humperdinck.
Oh, gosh.
Yes. Okay. Mind you, I do believe that you're a big fan of another American star, aren't you? And I believe you play his tapes and everything in your car.
Yes.
Who's that?
Neil Sedaka.
Oh. Do you like Neil, do you?
Yes.
Have you ever seen him live?
Oh, there's people in the audience who like Neil Sedaka as well. Nice. Neil Sedaka? Breaking Up Is Hard to Do. And what's the other one? There's not something to do with rain. Laughter in the rain. And what time's it? Got to watch every minute here. Neil Sedaka. Oh, Carol. He did other. Breaking Up Is Hard to Do. Well, look how fucking old he is, man. Back then?
This is like almost. Don't
you leave my heart in misery. Still gone. You go, then I'll be blue. Cause breaking up is hard to do. Nice dancing, nice quiz. That's how people dance now.
We're going to see and hear him live tonight because we have arranged for him to sing a song especially for you. And here he is. Come in, Neil Sedaka.
Yes. I see. Oh, long hair at the back. Oh, look at you. He's went for the French look.
Oh, look at that. She is. We have a saying over here, and I can tell by the look on her face, she is totally gobsmacked.
Really?
Yes.
What will my wife say?
But she adores you. Your biggest fan.
Yeah. And I wrote a song for you, our Carol.
You did, a long time ago.
Oh, he loves that hair at the back, doesn't he?
A lovely classical piece. For our Carol here,
yes, I would love to sing for you. I have a new album called Classically Sedaka.
Yes, that's why you're here.
I've written to the great masters the classical melodies. I've written original lyrics to the classical melodies. I'd like to dedicate one to you.
Oh, isn't that lovely? Oh, that's wonderful. Well, the piano's waiting over there.
Oh, he
We're
loves
waiting
that.
As well, aren't we, everyone? Yes. So if you'd like to stand by, I'll let her faint on the settee.
Oh, he loves that. Can I have...
Very much in.
Can we make it... I don't want... It kind of flops down at the top. Can we hairspray the top, but sort of keep the back? Like, so that it moves. I don't want that flopping about and have to fix it, but can I have it? We can do that, Neil. We can do that. There you go.
I walked on, and there's the children, when they were oh so small.
What do you mean you put the words to classical tunes? This is goat words. This is Ness and Donald.
If I can only turn the clock back.
All right.
Back to the day.
Neil, I think it's been done. Right, anyway. We need to skip. Are you going to go for the high? High note. Right.
Hands of time.
Here it is.
Turning back.
Turning back. Right, go.
The hands of Turning back.
Right, I thought that was the end. Right. Run out for a kiss, go. It's tradition. No, do that. King, lit on the couch and flip that hair.
Static. The audience, they are over the moon out there.
Oh, he loves that. I see it.
They are over the moon.
Ooh. Ooh.
We're all ecstatic, aren't we?
Yes. I enjoyed it.
And she's thrilled. Now, I know you're going to take our Carol off to the party penthouse suite, aren't you?
I hope so.
Yeah, for a little drink of champagne. Carol off to the party penthouse suite, aren't you?
I hope so.
Yeah, for a little drink of champagne. The party penthouse suite, aren't you?
I hope so.
Fucking hell. He almost looks serious. She's looking away like that. Oh, don't, Neil. He's like, oh, so it's like he's like serious, look. It's like he's serious. Look. Looking at her lips. Look. Look, no, I'm doing that. Oh my god.
I hope so.
If a little
looking up to that. Oh, I hope so.
Oh. You're going to take our Carol off to the party penthouse suite, aren't you?
I hope so.
If a little drink of shampoo up there. We'll save a glass.
I hope so.
If a little drink of shampoo up there.
I hope so.
We'll save a
another hope so. Another hope so. You hear that? Another hope so. Listen. I wonder if I've got to get three.
Carol off to the party penthouse suite, aren't you?
I hope so.
If a little drink of shampoo up there.
I hope so.
Or save a glass for me. But before you do
I hope so.
I mean, I've been noticing in our audience out
there. I hope so. I hope so. I hope so.
Young lady.
Shampoo. Just a wee funny way of saying, it's like saying shampers. It's like saying shampers.
She's sitting over there in a check jacket, and I know she's absolutely dying to meet you. Do you mind?
No.
You don't mind? Well, surprise, sweetheart. Come down, say hello to Neil.
I hope so. This is it. We're moving in. We're moving into Basel. I hope so.
Hello.
Oh, I dearly hope so.
Say hello to Neil.
How are you?
And Carol over there.
Are you coming up to the penthouse as well? I hope so.
Well, hello, Alison. You did enjoy that with Neil, didn't you?
Oh, glad. I hope so.
You're glad you met him now?
Definitely.
Yes. I hope so.
Will you stay and have a chat with me?
Like, what do we call it? Like, oh! Like Arnie. 2 weeks. 2 weeks. Is that what he says? 2 weeks.
Are you glad you met him now?
Definitely.
I hope so.
Well, you stay and have a chat with me. In the meantime, you take our Carol off up to the party penthouse suite. Ladies and gentlemen, Neil Sedaka and Carol. Well, Alison, who are you with tonight, love?
I'm with my mum.
Where's your mum?
She's up there in the audience.
Oh, well, let's make it a family occasion. Look at that. She's thinking low in her seat. Come on, mum. Come on, mum, make it a family.
No, I can't. No. No.
Well, let's make it a family occasion.
Just her name. Just you and Ma getting mentioned. Oh, fuck.
Love.
I'm with my mum.
Where's your mum?
Is up there.
Oh, well, let's make it a family occasion. Look at that. She's thinking low. No. Come on,
no.
Mom.
What? No. I can't. Don't make me.
Join me on the Cilla.
I can't. Don't make me. This isn't helping. Justice for Basil, by the way. Justice for Basil.
You sit next to me, all right? Have a sit next to the... Now, I know all about you, Agnes. It is Agnes, isn't it? I know all about you because this lady over here, your lovely daughter, Alison, is...
Basil, wasn't he plastered? Justice for Basil.
Tell me all about... She did, yes. And your story is a very moving story, I have to say. Now, you were born in India, weren't you?
That's right.
And you had a very tragic childhood because when you were just, well, a little baby, your mum had to go in hospital. And I do believe the last memory you had of your mum when you were very young, you don't have any more memories of her because she never, ever recovered after that, did she? Now, I know you did have a brother, Ian, and brother, Basil, but your Ian and yourself, you went to live with various relatives in India, is that right? Mm-hmm. But big brother Basil stayed with his dad.
Basil. I wonder what happened to Basil. I wonder what happened to his Basil one. Anyway.
When you were old enough, you were put in a boarding school in India. Mm-hmm. Yes? But that must have been a very sad time for you, especially at holiday times. Because Alison tells me here that, you know, when the holidays did come, you had to wave goodbye to your friends and you were left behind. Well, you did grow up and you married, you fell in love with your dear husband, Alfred. Mm-hmm. You had three children, and in 1954, you all came over to Britain to live.
That's right.
And you've been here 41 years. I do know that a couple of years ago, you and your dear husband, you did go to Bournemouth to retire, but sadly, Alfred died as well. Mm-hmm. And then not long after that, your brother Ian died too. Mm-hmm. So your only closest living relative...
Is who is that again? Your only closest one is... what was his name? Brian, was it? Basil, that was it, Basil, aye. I wonder what happened to him.
Your big brother, Basil, still lives in India.
Mm. Yeah. He's still in India, isn't he? Is that right? Aye.
And it's 41 years since you've seen him.
Mm-hmm. I've not seen him for 41 years. Well, that'll be 42, 45 years, 50 years. What was his name again? Bertie? Basil. Bah, my memory.
Well, he's not in India now. I am. He's right there waiting to say hello to his little sister once again. Come in, Basil. Say hello to your sister.
Boom. Let's see that again.
He's wrote.
It's the stagger after it. The person before him who came through at the one of them banged into it, and the one before looked like they banged into it, but possibly just moved out the way, just kind of the way they walk. But now it's just looking like, no, he's no steaming.
Your sister.
But it's a stagger after it looked bang, and then that look, oh, you know, kind of wee lean to the side, lad. You didn't see that. He's no fazed by it. Like, normally when a person bangs into something, they go like that, and he's no, because he's blitzed. But you can see he comes round the couch, look, he comes round the couch, all right. Look. Nae cunt who's got a drink in him can walk around a couch is impossible.
As we smile to the years, we take a life is full of surprises. It's a pride that I can come through. Life is full of surprises. I did surprise in my life is you.
Well, that's all we have time for this week, I'm afraid. I'd like to say a very big thank you to everybody who's taken part in tonight's show, especially Sylvia Anderson, Steve Davis, Sasha Distel, Engelbert Humperdinck, and Neil Sedaka. We'll be back with lots more surprises next week. So, ta-ra, then, ta-ra.
Pose like Jesus on the cross, please. Thank you.
Her life is full of surprises. Her life is full of surprises. And the night is a part of my heart. It's
we did it. We made it. We made it. We did it. We made it. I did prediction instead of raid. Thought it would have fucking mattered. No, it would have mattered. Prediction thing would have came up and I would have been like, close. Efrain Winslow, thanks for the bits. Missed that Sedaka hand touch on the way back from the piano. Oh, I didn't see that. What did he say? I hope so. Neoth Brock, Kazi, thanks for the subs. Fucking brilliant, that. I hope so. I might get that clipped. You know, for like that.
I'm a professional streamer.
That kind of thing. Anytime I use the word hope. Banter box, aye, oh, definitely. I'll get that banter boxed. Everybody, thank you very much for the subs, the resubs, the bits and the tips. Mods, thank you very much for the modding. And everybody, just thanks for watching. Thank you very much for watching. I'll be back on tomorrow, Friday, with a bit of this and a bit of that. Maybe Mercilla, maybe Red Dead Redemption 2, maybe Dead by Daylight, maybe no Dead by Daylight. Ragnar, thanks to the sub. Steve, thank you very much for the subs. Until then, I'll send you at 10:30. So, ta-ra for now then. Ta-ra.